Heading toward the big holiday. A lot of people driving.
Yeah, it's the big getaway day, they call it. The big getaway day. A lot of people traveling.
Yeah.
I guess.
Ann said it during the break. This is like school.
Yeah.
The day before vacation.
Vacation and school.
You're just so distracted.
You're just like, look at the clock. When's eighth period?
Yep.
What's the matter, Sam? You don't know what this concept is yet?
Vacations is what I don't know what the concept is.
Huh?
Okay.
Long weekend.
Any type of vacation, long weekend, time off.
Yes.
You know, I hear you.
Rich Voss has entered the studio.
All right.
What's up, Rich?
It's Rich. Rich Voss.
How are you, buddy?
Miserable.
Why?
He's just always miserable.
We'll talk off the air. Good.
Off the air.
You can't just say that.
No, yeah. Things are good. I'm just things are, you know.
Why would you be miserable?
Would you get a
though?
Job here?
Why are you miserable?
You're still
wearing your wedding ring, so it's not that.
Oh, that's why it's miserable. No, things are good with her. Things are cool.
Good.
The other night, I go, let's have sex, and she just was so grossed out. She goes, I'll blow you. Because she didn't want to fuck me. It's like, I'll give you the consolation blowjob.
Yeah.
Why was she grossed out? Because it's me. I don't know. She just, you know, it's...
You know what it is? It's so unsatisfying to her that she would rather just, you know, get it over with, you come, and not have to go through the whole thing of you pumping away on her.
Well, she got mad, like, the other night. I wanted to... Sometimes, like, before, we used to have all these toys and stuff, and we don't have them anymore. And
what kind of toys?
You know, like a couple of vibrators, that little egg that you
shove in there. Look at his hands.
You know, jam in there.
When my daughter was first born.
Oh boy!
I had the egg going. This is true. I had the egg going, and you vibrated on there. Okay, and we're both trying to look at porn, right? And I'm all like, I got the egg. I'm looking at porn, and the whole time I'm shaking. The bassinet because the baby's crying.
That's are you serious?
Yeah, this is because she was sleeping in our room.
Ugh.
But like last week, she got grossed out because I wanted to use, we didn't have any toys, and I wanted to use like a dildo a little just to fool around. You know what I mean?
For your own ass.
So I have these like Powerade drinks that come in the plastic tubes.
Oh, no.
You know what I'm talking about? Like they're,
I
like,
can imagine, yeah.
But they're shaped like that, so I went downstairs, and I had it under the sheet so she wouldn't see it, and I get ready to use it, and she looks and goes, what the fuck is wrong with you? But what's the difference? Because there's, you know, Powerade juice, and it still serves its purpose.
Girls don't want just anything shoved up their pussies.
I found that out. Yeah. They're so like...
That's like fraternity shit.
And the outside of that thing has been in, like, on a store shelf. And,
oh, no, yeah. I cleaned it off. I cleaned it off.
Was it plastic or is it hard plastic?
It's a hard plastic. It works. I've used it. It's not fucking, you know, if it can get through me, it can get through that looseness. So she didn't want to do it. She just grossed
What'd she
out.
Say?
She goes, what's wrong with you?
What the fuck's wrong with you, right?
Yeah, but I don't know. I'm not trying to be funny. I'm just saying that, you know, so.
She tried to fuck her with a Powerade beverage.
Yeah.
And now she doesn't want to give you any puss? That's funny.
I want to see what this thing looks like.
Yeah.
It's just one of, it's a tube.
Right.
But is it rough on the end?
No, it's perfect.
Yeah. How wide is it?
There might be a, I don't know if there's like a little jagged edge.
Because they absolutely make products knowing that girls, you know, might just.
Yeah,
use
what's
it for
wrong
something
it?
Else. We've done that bit too. Some of the things that they
use.
Yeah, just how they shape their products. You know, those electric toothbrushes. No one gave a fuck that you could get your teeth cleaner. They had something else in mind and said, I think we could sell a lot of these things, make them believe that you could get your teeth cleaner, especially because they have the little cap that you put over the brush. You know what I mean? So that's not going to hurt anybody.
Yeah, vibrating.
We were at a flea market once, just walking, and there was a used vibrator, like, you know, on the, like, oh, honey, you know that vibrator we were looking for? Like,
at a flea market?
At a flea market.
A used like, vibrator?
They had one on the table?
Yeah, you know, how people put their shit out there. And it was the old white one, you know, that you get a screw in the big batteries.
Oh, I forgot about that shit.
the old white.
Well, it's not a vibrator. It's a muscle relaxer. Yeah. Yeah, a massage tool.
I would love to be in some of these meetings because you know they don't. I'll go back to the toothbrush. They like girls will fucking use this, you know.
They love the shower heads. Yeah. That
right, all that down, stuff.
You know.
Oh, fucking brush handles. Toothbrushes.
Sometimes we'll do a brush thing, me and my wife. Like, she'll put a brush in my ass, and then I'll comb her hair like that for foreplay.
Why are you doing bits?
Because I'll tell you, it started becoming a bit when he said, I'll comb her hair.
Right.
It was the truth when he said, she'll put the brush handle in my ass, and he made it into a funny bit.
Yeah.
Why am I doing it? Because
that line kills. Where did it kill?
Everywhere on stage.
Yeah, I know. Why did you feel like you had to do that
everywhere.
Right now?
Everywhere.
You're doing fine.
I just feel like, you know, I got a little Regan in me, so I figure I'd throw that out.
Yeah. It's a great line, but what are you doing?
I know, I'm
sorry. We're having a good conversation.
I've never done a bit in my life on this show.
There's some comedy here. You had to go with the guarantee.
Yeah, well,
I want to see what he, the Gatorade thing. What is it called?
It's like some kind of power.
Powerade.
You know, like, it's like a
in little tubes? I've never seen these
things. Just like a protein drinks.
You don't even know.
Well, I don't remember the name of it. You take it after you work out.
And they're in little tubes.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. It was on
okay.
It was on that show.
Protein.
Yeah, like that. Yeah, that's exactly the tube.
Okay.
Right there.
Yeah.
All right. That's very dildo-ish.
She shouldn't be that mad.
That's hawkish.
The mistake you made, you should have painted it black.
That's
yeah.
Sorry.
Put foreskin on
it. Black.
And it was nice and cold, you know?
So she won't touch it anymore?
Yeah, don't you like cold? Don't you? Have you ever got blown with a girl that put ice cubes in her mouth?
No.
You, a guy?
A warm, wet mouth.
Yeah, we learned that years ago.
I had a girl blow me with pop rocks in her mouth.
Does nothing for me, that shit. I don't need a blowjob spiced up.
What?
Yeah. You're supposed to drink wet, sloppy mouth.
You're supposed to drink warm tea and then have ice water. Remember Laura Korn?
Who could forget?
What happened to her?
Her hijinks.
She's on someone's foot.
Who gave you guys a present?
Well, it was, I don't know.
Mrs. Fields.
Is that really came from the company?
No, it's a forgery.
No, we decided to fucking go to Mrs. Fields before the show and get a basket of cookies. Of course it came from the company.
But why?
Because we're fucking really important people.
Love us.
We could sell a lot of products, so this is plugola shit.
Yeah.
See, we're talking about Mrs. Fields cookies now. See how smart they are?
That's pretty smart.
Yeah.
You want that, right? You want to wrap that up for somebody this Christmas or Hanukkah, whatever the fuck.
That's going to my family's house there for Thanksgiving.
That's a good idea.
That's what I'm going to bring over. Hi.
It's a huge basket of cookies.
A bottle of wine.
Looks terrific.
I'm set.
I can't have any cookies.
Why?
I'm trying to eat better.
How's that working out for you?
It looks great.
Not bad.
No, he does. He's exercising, losing weight.
He's losing weight, but what does he do with his face?
Oh,
that's just hurtful.
Is it 1960?
Hurtful and mean.
Why would you do that?
Because
it's the day before Thanksgiving. We're all in a very good mood, and
we're all thankful about our friendship.
We're being nice.
What are you gonna do? What do you do for Thanksgiving?
Go to my sister's house, the rich house, the fucking
is that what you do?
Mansion.
Where's that? Jersey?
Fucking yeah, baby.
That she didn't earn.
She
didn't earn. That bothers you.
What?
Did she earn it or?
Oh, she earned it. That bitch is a hard worker.
What does she do?
Drug companies.
She sells drugs. Fuck. Nice.
I mean, she used to work with Warner Lambert, then Pfizer took him over. She had major stock. She's like always like a fucking big gig in these drug companies.
So she got a nice house?
How much? Fucking makes your house look ghetto.
How much is she worth?
You don't have to fucking be mean.
But it doesn't make your house look ghetto.
No, it is. It's fucking.
What makes. Her house so much better than Ant's.
It's on top of a hill looking where you could see New York, the view of New York from the hill. It's just beautiful. It's the outside is like nice like rocks, not like Italian stucco like everybody else, you know, in his family has. It's not, you know, there's no like horrible statues in it.
Why don't you give Sam write the address off air? We can look at it on Google Maps or Google Earth.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Oh, I don't know if good. I know the address.
Oh,
how would it's I on your phone?
I don't know if I know the address.
And he goes, how would I know that? Because it's your sister.
I don't know if I know the address.
Do you know your sister's address?
Yes, I do.
Or your brother's address?
Yes, I do.
I don't. I have it written down.
I'd be able to find it on Google Maps.
Or at the very least, I could, maybe not the exact number, but I would be able to pinpoint.
You zoom in, you're all right, it's a right turn there.
Yeah,
and,
why don't you just get the right down one of the streets, it's right, like on.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. And then Sam can go look it up. We can take a look at this house.
Yeah. See what the hell the hubbub is.
How much is she worth?
Yeah, how much?
How much?
How much is she worth?
How much?
More than $2 million.
What city?
Oh. Does she have kids?
No.
Husband?
Huh? No, she's married. Her husband's like one of the best carpenters on the planet.
He Jesus?
Yes.
How much are they worth?
33.
Well, yeah. She's got a yacht, string of Pelopones. She has everything.
A what?
He got it.
Yes, Pelopones.
Of course.
She has a yacht, nice cars.
Best callback ever, by the way.
Oh, yes,
what is a string of
Pelopones?
What is a string of Pelopones?
Rachel, you've come back.
Oh, is that we're close?
That's the road, right?
Right, Rich?
You don't know. You wrote it down.
Rich, yeah. It's a map. You just got to know which way you have to turn once you get...
Yeah, do you know
this
how to get
there?
This is
an aerial view.
He's looking at
it's
it.
Like, I thought we were looking at broccoli. Trees.
Yeah. That's Bruce's cousin.
Yes.
Do you know where
broccoli.
It is?
Broccoli.
Oh. You recognize that baseball field?
No, it's up top. I'll text her. Hold on.
It's up top. What does that mean?
It's on top of
the
mountain.
I think he meant north.
It's on top of the mountain.
Old Smokey.
All right, I'll text her and ask for her.
Right.
Is she up right now? Selling her drugs?
I don't fucking know. I don't really talk with her.
Why?
He's jealous.
No, because she's tired of. She's embarrassed by him.
How's your brother doing?
Oh, I got to call him.
It's a really short.
You're on the radio.
I called him.
Hey, turtle hands, fucking get to it. Use those reptilian things on your fucking wrists.
How is your brother doing?
I guess he's doing okay. The last time I talked to him, the hurricane didn't affect him.
No.
Well, so, you know.
Well, the diabetes did, though.
Oh, God, that's right.
Ow.
Sorry, Rich.
That didn't happen.
Now, how's he doing, though? He's all right?
Yeah, yeah.
Rich has Asperger's.
You think so?
A partial autism, yeah.
Why?
Because emotionally, he's just...
dead inside.
But he's a good guy. I love Voss, but he's a fucking... he's autistic.
Maybe because he's seen a lot of hard things growing up.
Nah.
It just made him dead inside.
Even Bonnie knows
hardships.
It.
Hardships.
Yeah, I mean, my life hasn't been easy, but I've
why don't you like your sister?
I'm not saying it's been
easy. I don't dislike her. She's just too... she's so left-wing, it's beyond control.
Oh, politics will break up families.
It's just too, you know...
I don't talk politics with family members.
Self-hating Jew?
Fuck that.
Lefty?
Yeah.
You know, it's just...
why would you eat in the middle of a discussion?
Because he's that damn good at this. He knows it.
Rich.
Tell him, Rich. Tell him.
You don't know what you're doing.
You're in the middle of a conversation.
I'm bad with it, but literally he's in mid-discussion. What time? Hold on. Okay.
He picked the worst time to take a bite.
To take a bite, yeah.
Usually
yeah.
we go, I think I could sneak a bite in. Yeah, and then once in a while you get caught, and you're like, oh, fuck.
You do have to time the bites, or even the size of the bite.
Right.
Like, he took a giant bite.
Right. When he knew he had to talk.
And then he'll chew gum, and then, like, knowing he has to. Like, if you're the center of attention at the moment, like, if you know you have to talk, you don't.
Then you got to watch that sandwich and not take a bite.
That's a good point. But, you know, people are listening.
So who cares if.
Eating?
Wait, who cares if she's left leaning? That means you guys discuss it. Because I'm sure I got family members that don't think the same way politically, but I don't discuss it with them.
They're so closed minded. It doesn't matter what you say, they'll come up with. They're closed. My father's like that. He's so, you know, liberal. And it's not even being to one side. They're too much to one side.
Yeah.
You know.
And have to bring it up a lot.
There's no reason with them, you know.
No reasoning?
Yeah. Yeah, whatever, you know. It's still early. I'm going to kick in.
So why go to your sister's house at all? Why
don't you just... my kids will be there. You know, where else are we going to go? Me and Bonnie, I'm not going to...
So what happens? You just sit on a couch by yourself and watch the clock?
No, we go there and I fucking... what?
You're just always entertaining.
What did I say?
You said,
that's the beauty.
Where else do we gonna go?
Like, can you replay that? Now?
It's just these little moments that shouldn't even
your
be
mouth,
acknowledged.
Your
but,
mouth is just a gold mine.
Oh God, it's fucking amazing.
Every time
so you was yours for an escort service.
And then here he is. Rich is brilliantly quick.
That's funny.
He is the opposite. He's as dumb as you can be and as absolutely comedically brilliant and fast as you can be.
Within seconds of each other.
Nothing in the middle.
Which is so strange.
It should be, you should have your own show like about one person who does like, it's like a cop buddy movie, but it's you. It's called Dunderhead and Rich.
Does your sister look like you?
Ugly.
She's ugly? You're saying on the radio that your sister's ugly?
Spitting image.
Yes, she does.
So she's your twin.
Oh, he's got it. Let's hear it.
Oh, here.
Hold on. No, Rich, hold on. You put your headphones on. You're playing audio. Okay, Travis.
So why go to your sister's house at all?
My kids will be there. You know, where else are we going to go? Me and Bonnie. Where else are we going to go? Oh, that was her landline.
Texted her landline. That wasn't Dunderhead. That wasn't Rich. That was Dunderhead.
Yeah, Dunderhead and Rich. New this fall.
Yeah. It's like Cagney and Lacey. Or who's the other one? Yeah. Something in Isles. You know the one I always see it on Broadway?
Rizzoli and
Isles. It's the worst name. It might even be a good show. Have you seen
it? It's terrible sounding, that name.
How is it?
Sound good.
Jake and the Fat Man. That was one.
Yeah.
I think Cannon was in that.
Oh, yeah.
Bobby has a sitcom?
I was just going to, see, this is why he's quick. I was just going to show you a picture of Jake and the Fat Man from the other day. There he is. Jake and the Fat Man.
Oh, look at it. Oh, my God.
Let me see.
You're going over Bobby's for Thanksgiving there, Jim?
Oh,
yes.
Let me see Bobby. What is he doing?
What the hell?
That's Bobby?
Yeah.
What is he doing?
I don't know.
That's...
How long ago is that?
Two nights ago at Del Frisco's.
Oh, man.
I can't believe that's the same guy I met, maybe 8 years ago, 9 years ago?
That young Hispanic, Hispanic man.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah. You know, speaking of fat slobs, Iraq comes to mind. And
but he's not even here.
I know. But do you know where Iraq was? I was looking through some photos that somebody was posting on Twitter last night. ONA photos or something. I don't know what the fuck I mean. But it was like he had pictures from all NEW shit.
Yeah, it's a Twitter account called OA Photos.
Yeah, OA Photos.
Just posting all the old shit.
Yeah. And there was some Mulcahy's photos from 2000.
Oh,
and in the crowd, right up front, a very young E-Rock.
No!
Standing there.
Can we find
looking
those?
Up.
Really?
Looking
obviously,
up. Is that the Mulcahy's one?
Yeah, obviously.
All right,
before,
start the first. No, keep going.
It's 2000.
No.
Remember this?
No.
Hold on.
Get to the E-Rock one, though, first. No.
Wow.
Just keep going.
No.
Oh, my God. We used to be fucking famous.
No.
Look how famous we used to be.
No.
Oh my God.
No.
Spaz.
No. No.
Spaz.
There it is.
Oh, my God.
That's young Nagel.
What the fuck?
Zoom in.
Look at the psychotic look on his face.
He's an audience member?
Yes. Yeah.
He's studying us.
Look at him. Look at his
Everyone
face.
Everyone else is just having a good time, and E-Rock is studying
us.
That's
a guy that's going to shoot somebody.
Yes.
He's just studying
us. I was going through those last night. I'm like, is that fucking E-Rock?
Wow.
Young Mr. Nagel.
Before he worked for us.
I got blown that night on the
E-Rock.
Bus. I got blown on the bus by a girl, and she spit my cum in the top of the fucking keg and wrecked it for everybody.
Wrecked the keg.
Was that the same,
really?
same show?
I don't think so.
Oh, no?
No, because we used to go to Mulcahy's a lot.
Oh, maybe I might have been there for that. Okay.
Maybe it was. I don't know.
I only remember that being once. Sam, go back to us for a second.
Wow. Hang on 1 second. Young E-Rock.
He's like, in
everyone
two
else
pictures.
Everyone else is just partying and having a good time, and he's just like staring.
He's
oh, you know
looking
what?
Like
that was Spaz. I didn't really know Spaz.
And he's in deep thought.
He was, right? There's the next picture I think he's in also. The very next one.
I kind of like That's the OA creepy. Photos
yeah,
Twitter account.
Yeah.
There's young E-Rock.
He's finally updating that again, so do yourself a favor if you're...
Look at him just cultivating that additional chin that'll be coming in shortly.
There it is.
He's just cultivating it there.
It's just beginning right
there.
Right?
Yeah,
the beginning stage.
Yep.
Wow.
That's pretty good.
What is he seeing that's different than everyone else? Because everyone else is just pointing. Obviously, there's tits or something on stage.
Must have been a roast on the stage. Yeah, he was there, man.
Oh, God.
Loving it.
What? I just brought my penis on Rich's ass, but he didn't move.
Oh, he loved it.
Yeah, I had to back off.
Your sister lives in the middle of the trees, it looks like.
Up in...
Does this road look familiar?
Yeah, hold on.
There's no houses. Is it in here?
I don't know. No, that's not it. It's this way. This way.
It's this way. Okay. Fair enough. Watch out. Don't hit that car.
Major monster houses.
It's not in this like little gated thing?
No. No, she has a cobblestone driveway.
For a brother. Oh.
For a brother. You said she has a cobblestone. And Anthony said for a brother. that's a great description of someone being dumb. He's a real cobblestone.
Can you see it? No?
This is it.
What do you mean?
She lives in the road, house.
That's the address that you just gave me.
There's no house there?
Go that way or that way.
There's no house. Where do you want me to go?
Drive down the virtual road.
You can't drive down the road because that's where the address is.
Drive down the virtual road. All right, now look around.
Is that it?
Is that it?
Oh.
That looks like a cobblestone, though.
Yeah.
Oh, that might be it. Yeah, it's down there.
Oh, my God.
How do we know before you do? I've never been there.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Hold on. Keep going back. This way.
Is that it?
I can't see the house. Yeah, that might be it.
That's the house?
I mean, I can't go into the driveway.
What?
Why not?
We'll move up a little bit and we could get a better...
It's roads.
No, I know. Go up the road slightly to the left and you'll get a better view of the house.
Amazing. Look at that. You could just... Wow, so you could turn the whole picture like that. That's amazing.
I love it, Jimmy.
You do this on purpose.
I love Jimmy. Oh, can't see the house
from there.
Did
you go too far?
A little bit.
Oh, yeah. It's in the woods. Wow. Looks nice, though. That area, a lot of property. Pretty good.
Yeah,
For a
person that voted for Obama, there's not too many Obamas in the neighborhood.
Well, I'm sure they'll tax the shit out of her.
But that is interesting to me, people who have so much money that don't mind the height. The 50% death tax annoys me more than almost anything I've ever heard.
Crazy.
Mm. Yeah, you can't even leave your money for your family.
How fucking dare the government, man?
That's disgusting.
Wow. You have to start giving it away before you die. Less than 10,000 at a time.
If I wanted to live in Jersey, I could have a fucking pretty good... place.
What's that?
If I wanted to live in fucking Jersey, in the woods of Jersey.
Well, that's not the woods. That's overlooking New York. It's up in the mountains.
But it's still cheaper.
How far away from the city?
Huh?
How far away from the city?
That's probably 35 minutes, 40.
Perfect.
Mm. Yeah, that, believe you me, is the prime. A three-car garage with, you know, where you could build an apartment above it. Ceilings that are so fucking high.
How much does that go for? That house and the property.
I would have to say it's probably worth $2 million.
Jesus.
Ugh, does that make you sick?
Totally.
Yeah.
She just got stupid money.
No, because I got to live in Nassau County.
Right. All right.
Ish. Well, your house is great, though. I mean,
but you know what? For what I paid for it, I could go to a place in Jersey or fucking...
Castle.
Imagine if I moved to Pennsylvania. I'd own half the state. My state! Yeah.
They would call it your state.
My state. Anthony-vania.
And you could hunt year-round?
Yes.
In Pennsylvania?
Maybe the most elusive and clever of prey.
And in Pennsylvania? Pennsylvania, the number one capital in the country for white supremacy?
Is it?
Yeah.
How do you know that?
I just know. Well, how do you know anything? South. Someone taught you. or you read it somewhere. But they're number one in the country... You know, with York and different areas, it's per capital.
I don't believe that.
Oh, look it up.
What did you just say?
I said Pennsylvania is the number one state in the country for white supremacy per square mile.
No, you didn't say square mile.
Well, it doesn't matter.
What did you say? Per what?
Per what?
Per what?
Per capita.
Per capita.
Per capital.
Well, how else do you fucking say
per
it?
Capital.
Don't give me
per capita.
You're gonna learn something today. Per capita.
Per capita.
Per capital.
There's one capital per state, so it's always per one.
Yeah.
All right, boss. What are you promoting? It was a great appearance. Thanks for coming
thanks.
By.
Thanks. I'm at Gotham this weekend.
Yes. Okay, starting what?
Friday, Saturday, Gotham.
Very cool. GothamComedyClub.com to see Rich Voss.
Where are you New Year's Eve?
He'll be at the Comedy Shop in New Jersey.
Where's that? Are you in Jersey?
No, New Year's Eve. I'm in that place in the Poconos. I just got it.
You're not in Buffalo?
No, I'm there the week after. You're there. I'm there like the second and third or whatever, right after you.
I'm there New Year's week. I'm curious to how that club's going to do the helium up there. It's not open yet, I don't think.
Are
you opening it?
I hope not. I mean, because I wanted the bugs worked out first, but they said that they're working on getting it open fast. It's harder to go into a club when it's brand new because there's no history of people going there. People are weird creatures of habit. They build up mailing lists.
Yeah.
They go back. They see a few shows. It's always easier to go once the club's been
there. I'm there that, like, 3 days after you. All right. Which, I get the worst week of the year. The worst week, two
we'll
worst weeks.
We'll be back with David Tell and more with Rich Voss. Got David Tell coming in, too, today. Rich Voss in studio. His wife's not having sex with him anymore.
Yeah, we are. People.
Oh, it was just that one time?
Yeah. No, people on Twitter, this and that, they go, you don't have sex. We have sex with a married couple, you know, with a kid. It's, you know, we have it. If the kid comes and sleeps in our bed in the middle of the night, you know.
But in the middle of the night, you're not having sex. Sex.
Slap.
Don't you get it done before then?
Yeah, we get it. We probably, like, watch one Homeland, take a break real quick. Do it, then watch another Homeland. We do it in between snacks and shows.
Really? That's awesome.
And we get real quick.
In the middle of a Homeland marathon, you get a couple in, right?
Real quick, and we just knock it out.
Knock it out, get it done.
It's kind of the point where it's like a bathroom visit, just kind of doing a life function.
Yeah,
it's like brushing your teeth, you know, you just got to do it.
It's like a chore.
Yeah.
A chore.
Does she still get turned on by your hairy abs?
She gets turned on. I don't know. She goes, just pretend you're someone else every time. Closes her eyes. It's good. It is what it is. I'm older. After a while, I think you start to lose interest a little.
That's what everybody says when you're married.
You know, or even when you get older, I mean, you're just, you know, what the heck? I've done it all.
Language.
I've been with supermodels. I've been with, you know, major players. And after a while, you know.
Really?
It's just crazy. She thinks I'm gay because I say gay things, you know.
What are gay things?
Yeah, what are some of the gay things you say?
I remember getting fucked in the ass.
Jimmy. Nice. What do you mean you say gay things?
I don't know, jokes. When we're doing our podcast, my wife hates me on iTunes or Riotcast, and, you know, whatever. She just takes everything, you know.
One of the things you'll say that she'll take
wrong? Like if we're watching a porno and some girl's blowing a guy, I go, how lucky she is.
Oh.
Go look at her.
Well, the reason I call that gay is because she overhears you saying that out loud alone. I had higher hopes for that.
Yeah, I hear
it. It was too wordy.
Fair enough.
It's like,
yeah, it's true. I really did cock up
a documentary on a joke.
See, you should have just left it at wordy.
I should have. There's not a lot of energy in here, and I always notice that right before a holiday and a break.
We said that.
We usually have crazy shows before these, but I'm so angry at my fucking manager right now.
What happened?
I'll tell you off air. It's nothing major, but it could just be, if it's one of these scatterbrain things, I'm just so, I'm hoping I'm wrong, but I have a feeling he was supposed to do something that he didn't do.
Oh.
And if it hasn't been done, I am fucking livid. It's like,
what's a manager?
A guy who you expect to do things who forgets.
Your guy is so good. Like, as talking to, like, I don't know about business, but he's the best guy to hang out and talk with.
Yeah, he's a great guy, and he's a smart guy, and he's a he's great at communicating with people, and people like him. But he's scatterbrained sometimes, and it makes me, like, so angry I want to bite myself. Boy.
Because you're really, persistent or whatever. What's the word? Not persistent. Kind of like... obsessive. You're...
But when I say, let's call...
You're responsible.
When I say, let's call somebody, and I hear, no, Jim. No, okay, I will. And it's like, that person hasn't been called or whatever. Like, that makes me fucking nuts.
Would that get you madder than Kenny not bringing your pillow on the road, your special pillow that you bring?
I don't bring a special pillow.
That's what I heard, that you bring a pillow.
You heard incorrectly.
Oh, okay.
You mean my neck pillow?
No, not your neck pillow.
That's what I bring. I fly with.
Pillow. that falls right through your head because you don't have a chin.
I understand.
Every time you wake up, it's on your forehead on the plane.
Oh, wow.
When's the last time you flew coach? Like, do you always fly first class?
Yeah.
By getting bumped up or in the contract? I know, not with Leno, I mean club, gigs.
When I'm paying for it, I'll either upgrade with miles, I'll fly on miles, or I'll pay for it. But I pay for very few flights overall, so it's worth it to me.
Hmm.
It's a write-off.
But, like, it's almost impossible to get bumped up now.
Yeah, that's why United, that merger, fucking airline sucks my dick.
Oh, I gotta tell you.
Continental was pretty good.
Yeah.
United is fucking...
What's wrong?
They're just terrible.
I've flown United a bunch of times.
My miles are expiring. Continental miles never did. They're just...
What do you mean expiring?
They're just...
If you don't use them, they're expiring? What do
you mean? No, in mid-use, they actually kick you off the plane. They'll only fly you halfway to L.A. They boot you out over Minneapolis.
But how could they expire your miles?
Exactly. I don't know.
Mm.
They're absolutely terrible.
Let me tell you about those scumbags, United. I had a pair.
But who else could you fly? We're running out of options.
American or Delta, I've been flying.
We're running out of options.
Do you know how bad you have to fuck up to lose me as that airline? How loyal I was for years.
Loyal. You got us all involved.
I got him involved.
I didn't give a fuck about flying until Jimmy started telling us. Now we all do what you do.
They don't care.
When I flew, I had those sunglasses you told me, the Maui Jacks that were like $300.
You got them.
No, not anymore. They were stolen out of my golf bag, along with another thing, a harness.
I think you told the story already.
No, I didn't tell the story.
I think Bonnie told us.
No, but here's the thing. Maybe I did. I don't know. All I know is I'm not getting the money back, but they caught the TSA agents in Newark that were stealing the stuff.
Okay? TMB?
What's that?
TSA?
Yeah, TSA.
Yeah.
They caught them. They caught them.
Sneaky.
But yet my stuff was stolen. And...
But is United, hold on, if it's a TSA agent and not a United employee, wouldn't that be the TSA
I handed my bags to United. I didn't hand them to TSA.
Point being, that's true. You wanted your glasses back. Say, hey, you know who stole them, so give them back.
Did they approve that he took your stuff, or they just know an agent was stealing?
An agent was stealing. Same thing happened in Miami. I had stuff stolen in Miami, and then... 2 months later, I read Miami TSA agent arrested for stealing electronics and stuff.
So what's their response?
No, we don't cover sunglasses. We don't cover. Just a list of things they don't cover.
All the stuff they steal.
That's why they steal it. You know, so they don't cover it. So you basically, if you have something stolen, like they don't cover electronics. So if you have some electronics stolen out of your suitcase, you better say pants. You know, and these are the people. What?
Just a mid-story cough.
Oh,
sorry.
I'm just. It's furious.
It is furious. Yeah.
But Southwest, you want to fly them, but you're scared.
Now, why would you want?
Because they don't have a hub, so it's like, you know, how do they work on it? They land and go, hey, does anybody have a hammer we could borrow? Or, you know, we got to work on the plane. Do any of you guys have a lift that we could use? Because where do they work on their planes? They don't have a hub.
I'm not even going to deal with that airline.
Southwest.
Remember the old days with the new airlines, and you go to this weird part of the airport that they just set up a makeshift place to check in? Like, what the fuck am I flying?
I love walking down memory lane.
Kiosk in the food court.
Right, exactly.
People's Express used to pay on the plane.
People's Express.
So I remember I was doing drugs and I'd get on the plane with no money because I did.
I'm going to make believe I've never heard the story before.
Should I tell it?
I actually don't know the story.
Huh?
I don't know the story.
I'm sorry. And I'll make believe I don't watch you in your nose half the show.
That's
He's quick. You're gonna get a beating back if you go after Rich.
But you have to.
Because he is a quick motherfucker.
No, tell the people story again. Listeners,
dude, it was a joke. We were just joking the other day. We tell the same five stories a million times.
So we do
the same shit.
I just didn't have any money, and spend on drugs. Then I would call the club owner and say, "You meet me at the airline and pay for my ticket," because they would come down the aisle.
to collect the money, and you go, oh, I forgot my wallet or
something. It was the weirdest thing.
No ID you didn't need back then? Wow.
No, man. I would fly to, I guess, Buffalo at the time on People's Airline. It was the weirdest thing. You actually paid on the plane.
Hey, Rich, I found your wallet. You must have left it over my house.
Right. Last time, Rich, and that's Continental bought People's.
They did.
Yeah, that's who Continental took over.
And it was cheap, too. How much was a flight?
Like, there were flights for $19.
Yeah, yeah.
$19 to, like, Buffalo or Boston.
Wow, that's
crazy. That's about right.
$19. There was some for $29.
Way less than $100. I remember that.
And United is so... This merger makes me
it's
fucking
not a merger,
sick.
Takeover.
Yeah.
Because so many Continental Sirius employees got fired.
XM.
Terrible.
They say merger.
Yeah, it is like the XM Sirius merger. And meanwhile... Yeah. We're the last bastion of XM left.
I don't see an XM sign anywhere.
Oh, no, they would love to just chop the XM off the Sirius XM logo.
Oh, I do see it.
Really brilliant on their part.
And they
get
rid of all the creative people. That's smart.
That was the fantastic management at XM was fucking...
Well, the management sucked, but there was some creativity over there.
How do you lose?
Didn't acknowledge.
Yeah.
The giant...
Everybody.
The giant lead.
Financial lead, technological lead. It's amazing.
Subscription lead.
Does maybe 4 shows a fucking month while everyone else suffers.
It's amazing.
Haven't had a raise in years. What's up, Rich? What happened?
Poor Sam.
What happened?
He's the only one who still has hopes and dreams. And
Sam?
Yeah, that shit will go away.
He's got that youth and things are going to get
30.
Better.
What youth?
Youth.
He hit 30 and look, he's slumping already.
Yeah.
You're 30?
29.
Exactly.
That's 30.
That's 30.
Yeah, it's not as optimistic.
He's got to work hard. He's got to work hard and hope because he's got a girl that's out of his league. So he's got to fucking, you know, he's got that going for him, which means things
which
like
nice.
Fucking house and everything else. So, you know, he's fucked. He knows it. He's fucked.
Okay.
Hold on. Grim,
Dave Attell. Attell, take
Grim
a seat.
The Grim Reaper just walked in.
Hey, Dave.
Oh, jeez.
Good morning, guys.
Take
How are
that
you, Dave?
Right over there.
You must be very happy. they got the guy who works at the kitchen at the cellar.
I know. This is the finally anti-Arab headline.
Is it?
Yeah. Post is more conservative.
Is that the Macy's Day Parade? What is that?
Holy shit.
How horrible. We're looking at the Post.
Yeah.
How horrible is that? That's your end where you're slowly being dragged by a low-end motorcycle. Or is that a moped? Down the streets of Kaboom Avenue in Gaza.
The wonderful Gaza Strip. Yes, yes.
That is a horrific picture. Right there.
I thought this was the upcoming Sons of Anarchy.
But they look like they're having a good time, you know?
Yeah, yeah. I was asking Ant, do you just go back to your regular job after that?
Yeah, just go to work.
Like, back at the Rocket Tunnel Factory.
Whatever.
You
know.
The Rocket Tunnel Factory.
But how do you pull off dragging a body to the streets on the back of a motorcycle and then go back to your regular job the next day?
God.
Look. I hope he's not black, because they would find a racist.
Well, exactly.
I understand.
You get so nervous talking about race, don't you?
Yeah. Not at all.
No?
No, never.
Say
never.
You're not afraid
say
to be called a racist?
Say the word.
What word?
Drop
you
it.
Know.
Drop
oh,
the big
right
unemployed?
Wow.
Illegitimate?
Good morning.
Wow.
Wow, David. Tell him I'm really sorry.
Let's go, Romney. You know what I also like, if you study the picture the way I do, they all use the same level of buzz clipper. All the guys, you see that?
Yeah.
It's like all somewhere between downtown Brooklyn and
all the Hamas.
A 3.
And
give
all...
me a 3. We're going to be dragging a body. I want to look good.
And they all dress like Daryl Hammond.
Yeah, it's the picture of Hamas dragging the collaborator body.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's
on the cover of the New York Post.
You don't see that on Homeland. That's for sure.
No, you certainly don't. Why would you? Very realistic.
It really is. They've come quite a ways on with the newspaper covers. They wouldn't have shown dead bodies years ago.
Yeah,
they never really showed. They still have a problem showing dead American bodies.
Yeah,
they're like, well, we can't do that. But this guy, who gives a shit? You know,
because we're so well hung.
We don't really know if he died.
That is true.
Maybe he overslept for the Rocket Factory tunnel.
That might be a reverse photo. He might be actually dragging them. It's a strongman competition. Watch me drag 13 militants.
You know, there is definitely a homoerotic thing to it. All the guys on, you know, it's like, hey, man, you want to ride on my back? We're going to be dragging a guy through the thing. You know, you can hold on. It's a little nervous.
Yeah, ride bitch for this one.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does seem. Yeah.
Can you imagine sitting on the back of the bike, the smell blowing back on you?
Of just that whole region. Like, it smells like 5,000 years of.
And this one's got three guys on it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's what I call the fucking home run bike. Just got one guy in the middle.
Wow.
Shit. It really is a pretty fucked up situation. We did kind of want to get Rich's take on it because we ran through it yesterday. A lot of people very confused over all the years, very confused as to what the problem is there.
Listen, I've been all over Twitter with this, okay, arguing with your listeners that are pro-Arab and pro-Palestinian. And here's the thing. You can go throughout history, the embassies in Africa, the USS Cole, the World Trade Center, the bombings in Spain, the bombings in England, the World Trade Center again, none of those perpetrators were Jews, okay? So, and these are terrorist acts throughout the world, not only against Israel, throughout the world. So, what I'm saying is, not the most peaceful people on the planet.
What if the Palestinians say that Israel's behavior in Gaza is a form of terrorism?
What if Mexico says our behavior in Texas, okay, is unacceptable?
Oh, well. And then started firing missiles into Texas.
Okay. You know, what if Mexico wants their land back in Texas and California?
But maybe that's the answer. If instead of rockets, they were sending in meth, coke, and of course pot, then that would work. We'll be right back. I don't know.
That's okay. You do better with props.
All right, sorry. I didn't know you were so ramped up on this whole thing. Bring up the USS Cole. I didn't know that.
Yeah. No, what's the solution, Rich?
I didn't know you went for Blackwater.
What's the solution?
Part of the global security net.
We need solutions here, sir.
Solutions?
What's the solution? Yes.
Well, here's one of my solutions. Being that Israel is no bigger than New Jersey, surrounded by, I don't know, 10, 15 Arab states, and then into Africa with Libya and that continent, why doesn't maybe one Arab state say, hey, you know what, we'll take some of the Palestinians.
That's what I said yesterday,
And you guys take some. We'll do it. But they won't do it because it causes conflict against Israel. Even if Israel gave Palestinians land, they would still find another reason to attack. Arafat, when Clinton tried to sign a peace treaty with Arafat, Arafat said, well, we want Jerusalem. That's like America saying to Russia, okay, we'll give you D.C. It's not going to fucking happen.
Uh-huh.
They're not giving up Jerusalem. So if other Arab states chipped in and took some of the Palestinians, all right, then maybe there'll be a solution. And even with the Palestinians being taken, what's going to stop the crazy man in Iran who's anti-Israel, who's building a bomb? What's going to stop him? So how do you make him happy? You can't. It's impossible. There's too many enemies.
Israel's I don't like the fact that you just didn't remember his name. So you said
Ahmadinejad.
Oh, wow.
Ahmadinejad.
So what am I going to do? Right, I don't want to say it.
No. I stand corrected.
Yeah. All right?
This is serious.
With no posture.
Right. He remembers this because it's close to what he hears all the time. I'm a total clod.
But you could ask him. He knows. He knows the stuff.
Yes.
It's fighting, you know.
So there's going to be no solution, obviously, ever.
The solution is when other Arab countries get involved and say, we're going to help take the
Why would they do that?
This is still going to happen because I do believe that Hamas is like at the strong arm of Iran right now. And Iran supplying Hamas with the missiles that they're firing indiscriminately into Israel. And Israel is using this as an excuse to get rid of these fucking missiles. Well, maybe as a preface to an attack on Iran, because they don't want... Iran can't just indiscriminately shoot missiles into Israel right now. Well, but they can supply missiles to Hamas, and then they could lob them in, and that's exactly what they're doing.
Not only that...
why this conflict is going on, it gives Iran more time to work on their nuclear weapon.
Well, believe me, with fucking the shithead we elected into office, he's got all the time in the world to fucking do whatever he wants to do. Because no one is going to call him out unless the United States is behind more than just these do-nothing sanctions against Iran. This motherfucker is building a bomb. There's no doubt about it. And it just he just got elected for 4 more years. He can sit back. You won't hear anything about jobs anymore. Yeah. You won't hear about fucking the economy. It's done. He's done. He's got the job.
I think you might be wrong. Obama's been much tougher on foreign policy.
No, he hasn't.
Than I would have thought.
He's had a couple of high-profile things that have gone on. Of course, Bin Laden, huge. But that any fucking president, any president in office would have done that. I cannot accept the fact that some president would have gotten that intel and gone,
I think a president might have gotten that intel and told Pakistan. I don't believe a president would have gotten that intel and went into Pakistan.
Not this many years later. Yeah. Not with the history that Pakistan's had with fucking us as far as trying to get this motherfucker. Any president would have fucking done the same thing.
He's targeting, he's doing predator drone strikes more than, like, I like the fact that he's not, he's doing a lot, his own base hates what he's doing. They hate the way he's handling it. And I love the fact that he's...
Because he's just he just uses the base to get the job. He's doing shit that, of course, the military wants to do. He's, you know, he's not coming up with these battle plans for fucking predator drones.
No one is, but I'm saying he's...
But there are people. CIA, fucking...
I mean, no
Homeland
president.
Security.
No president, I mean.
But yeah, yeah.
But they either take the fall or they get the credit. I mean, Jimmy Carter didn't actually clean out those... whatever it was that caused the helicopters to crash, but he took the hit. Nixon didn't break in a... You know what I'm saying?
But also, when you have somebody that just decimated the military like Carter did, it was kind of his fault that they had inadequate equipment and training to go on a mission like that. So it all does come out in the whoosh.
When we overthrew the Egyptian government and took him out and put the Muslim Brotherhood in, who is a fraction of Hamas.
A what?
I said a fraction.
I know you.
Holy shit.
Why?
Don't answer.
That's not the word?
No, well, it's a good word.
Keep going.
All right. It is the word.
Okay, you would know.
A faction.
Greece is the word.
I meant faction.
Have you heard?
I meant faction. Early in the morning, I make mistakes, but you know where I'm coming from. The thing is, Egypt and Israel did have a peace treaty.
Yeah.
And Egypt, who is probably the biggest, most powerful country in the Middle East.
Biggest Muslim country.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now run by the Muslim Brotherhood.
Hey, then we can't cry. We want democracy. That's what they want. They elected them. Fucking stop saying we want them to have democracy. Let them elect who they want.
It sounds all well and fine, but, you know, Mubarak is another one of these guys who knew how to handle his fucking people.
Yeah, he was an ally of the U.S., and people want democracy. Let them vote in who they want.
Well, hey, let's just agree to disagree. What are you going to do, drag me through the streets on a motorcycle? I just want to know one thing. If Israel is the size of New Jersey, where is their Chris Christie? Would that be Netanyahu's?
I think that's Perez.
Yes. They needed 4 more guys to help drag him because he's fat.
Where is their Springsteen? Who is the Springsteen of Israel? Modi?
Yeah.
Go ahead. Who is it?
You ever been to Israel, Rich?
No, I was supposed to go when I was 16.
What kind of Jew are you?
Really? Have you been to Italy?
No, but I don't sit there professing and tattooing guinea shit on me.
Okay. Really? The Olive Garden.
The dry hair. The fucking horrible mansion you live in.
The curse of my people.
Yes. You know, by the way, as was pointed out to me by Ray Abu Salim, and I did know this and I forgot it.
Jesus Christ.
He won't be flying over the holidays, I suppose.
Like that. He has a tough time flying.
Are you thinking about the Oslo Agreement? I believe the right of return was the problem. That was, the right of return meant that Palestinians could come back and the Israelis wouldn't sign off on that because that meant that eventually the Palestinians returning would outnumber the Jews.
Right.
And they would be the majority.
Right.
So I think that was the main sticky point, was the right of return. Well, I'm not saying that's right or wrong. I'm just saying I think that's right.
Well, also, too, Israel gave land back in Egypt after the Six-Day War, which they...
Yom Kippur War.
No, the Six-Day War.
No, they gave back the Sinai Peninsula after the Yom Kippur. That's what the 73... Wow. Six-day war is where they won all the land. That was the win. That's when every Jew felt they were tall and had hair and everybody was great. 67.
And they gave it back after Yom Kippur.
Yom Kippur, yeah.
Which they were attacked on the holiest day.
Or as the Egyptians call it, the October War. See, they won't even agree on the name of the war. I mean, honestly, we call it the Vietnam War. What do they call it over there?
The fucking United Nations.
The Oliver Stone. Go ahead, dude. I'm sorry.
That's all right. It's too many...
Too many cooks spoil the broth.
That's it. The matzo ball soup.
But I think the real interesting thing is the rocket. I mean, a rocket attack. Let's say you're sitting in your house. Mm. All of a sudden, they blow a siren, and it's rocket attacks. What would you do? Mm. Honestly.
What would you do, Rich?
Yeah. I'd go into the basement, or I'd get my golf club.
No, not career-wise.
You get your golf club. I get my CDs, and I build it.
Yes, I'd hide behind
what
my teeth.
You do? I mean, like, that's the real, really scary thing about it. They have, like, rockets coming at them from all these different places.
That is some crazy shit.
And Tel Aviv, which is the, you know, like, the hottest town in Israel. It's, like, it's supposedly, like, the coolest town in the Middle East. Like, Tel Aviv. It's, like, you know, gay.
It's like Austin.
Yeah, it's like Austin. They've got their own, like, South by Southwest, Mideast by South something. you know, they got a really good Galleria there. I don't know what they...
Yeah. And the funny bone. There's
they got a funny bone there. Yeah,
they have a little kiosk for clitoral circumcisions.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, it can hit all the way through Israel. So it's pretty weird.
So what would you do?
If I was the Israelis, well, I kind of take the different track. I think the Palestinians should have some land there, you know, much like reservation style, like where they get, like, you know, their rights and everything. They could do whatever they want, sell cigarettes cheaper. And then, you know, they should just get through it already. I mean, it's like forever this thing's going on.
Now, okay, say they give them that land. Do you think there will be peace in the Middle East?
I don't think there'll ever be peace, mostly because that's the area of the world where people talk with their hands. So they're emotional. Like, everything is very emotional. Even, like I think I was watching, like, an Israeli show, and it was just, like, pure emotion. Like, it was, like, one of their... I guess, like, Good Morning Haifa or something. It was really just emotional. So, but I don't think there'll ever be a peace the way we know
okay,
it
so
in this great
never,
land.
If there's never going to be peace, why weaken your borders if you
well,
know?
Well, people have the right to, you know, have a life and all that kind of
they
stuff.
They were Jordanians before the Six-Day War, and all of a sudden this whole Palestinian thing popped up, you know, after the Six-Day War, where six countries try to abolish Israel. You
I don't know.
Know. So
they are in the middle of some shit there, aren't they? Yeah, they are.
I mean, I'm not gonna lie. I love hummus and falafel,
but not Hamas. Right.
No, big difference.
You know, I mean, the food is delicious.
Yeah, but what about like you know the whatchamacallit the Syrian thing that's happening over there? Are you worried about that? You know, like they're having their revolution. So
no
you think
one
it's
even
gonna be
cares.
The same thing?
Dude, there's a lot of dead people.
No one even gives a shit about Syria.
And we're not doing anything about it.
No.
Either. We don't get involved in that.
That documentary on Obama was interesting about how he's anti-colonial. Yeah. Like, the ones he's gotten involved with or so-and-so are where there's been a colonial influence. But in Syria, there's not. Mm. And I guess in Egypt, I guess. Well, I was kind of propped up. Mubarak was kind of seen as like a propped up U.S. ally.
But did you see?
So we kind of supported the revolutionaries.
In that documentary... The people throughout his life
That's what I'm
were all anti-Semitic,
anti-colonial.
Who, Obama?
Yeah, I mean, his professor, his mentor,
his grandparents,
father, right? All of them. Father, who was married, what, five times?
Yeah. What a piece of shit Obama's father was.
Yeah,
was
five
Obama's
times.
Father, a lump of shit,
he died drunk
guy.
Driving?
Yeah. Yes. He died in a car accident. He's fucking was just fucking everything that moved. Just an irresponsible lump of shit.
See, I would have said a great guy.
His son fucking idolized him, and he was nothing but a womanizing communist.
But his son never saw him. You can't. That's one thing you can't blame Obama for his father's.
Well, he should have said he was a piece of shit, and not write a book about the fucking dreams of my family. Fuck you.
Well, his dad was supposedly really super intelligent, but he grew up in like a weird thing where he wasn't able to, like, you know, I guess. Achieve all the goals that he had, and he also
his mom hated America so much he had to go find anyone else to fuck than an American guy. Anyone else? Where am I? Fucking Kenya?
Give me some of that dick. Where am I? Fucking
Indonesia?
I'm in Indonesia. Give me some Indonesian dick. She's amazing. She's like fucking, she's spreading a cunt open to Epcot.
But where she had one too many bad fucks.
Have some respect for the dead.
Wow.
Please. It's a holiday.
But I mean,
yeah, over there.
I mean, you saw
you're supposed to be thankful.
You saw the movie, all the professors, everybody was pure anti-America, anti-Israel.
People hate America.
These were major influences on his life.
Right.
So
you grow up in that atmosphere of just literally communists.
Yes.
Not just, oh, that guy's a communist. No, this guy identifies himself as a communist. His writings are communist, and he's one of the mentors that Obama had. It's just.
And besides, communist, anti-Semitic, and also, you know, you're.
I don't mind that part.
Yeah, well,
yeah.
But the thing is, why can't we disagree without being violently disagreeable?
Oh, yeah. Right. Yes.
I didn't make that up.
That's an excellent point.
You want a bagel with some lox?
I was kind of hoping after that whole Jewy Jew talk that you're going to pull out a nice ham and rye. You know, like a real...
Yeah, he's a trooper, Rich.
Right.
And that's what I think. A kielbasa? Anybody?
How long is this? Can this last without it going bad?
10 minutes.
What are you eating there?
It's cream cheese and lox and capers.
When did you get it?
Wow.
Oh, capers. Nice.
You take it out of a bomb shelter?
Holy.
You just bought it.
Yeah, capers. Yeah. Well, how long
does
it last?
Why are there crimes?
How long does it last before it stinks up the room like bad poon? Like 10 minutes.
It's a
weird
kip-el.
Early morning. On the road, you don't eat that.
What are you talking? This is a good breakfast. It's light.
Shut up and eat it.
There's no way you're going to find... Jew food like that.
Wait till the break.
Where you find that
you're
in Alabama?
The middle of discussion, and you're going to eat a bagel.
Yeah, we got some of that right behind this tree here, Jew boy. Why don't you come back here?
That's where you're
wrong. Glock kosher. Where can I find it here in Pittsburgh?
When I go on the road, I go to the supermarket, I buy my food, and I bring it back to the hotel and put it in the refrigerator.
Wow, you
fascinating.
That is so...
This guy wants in on your...
We know exactly where you stay now. The Comfort Inn.
Yeah, exactly.
The bedroom thing.
Kevin in New Hampshire.
I put it in the refrigerator near the hot plate and the three spoons you're afraid to touch.
I love those sweets.
Me too.
And the horrible coffee maker.
Breakfast.
I walk in, I immediately flip the mattress out of habit. I just flip it over. Fresh start.
Let's say hi to Kevin in New Hampshire. Kevin.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Jimmy's right. Anthony, you're wrong. You've been saying for a year now that any president would have gone in and did what Obama did to take out Bin Laden.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, Google it. Google it. Google it, dude. Every Republican.
What does he mean by
every Republican railed against Obama during the first campaign in 2008. Because he said that he would do that. They all called him naive.
Shut the fuck up. No, they didn't say. So Obama said, hey, if we find Bin Laden, I'm going to kill him. And Republicans said, oh, stop it. That's terrible.
Yeah, what do you mean, sir?
They were looking for him. Shut up. You fucking revisionist history lib cunt bag. Fuck you and your mother's cunt.
Wait, sir, what do you mean?
Shut up.
What do you mean?
Shut up, lib. Shut up, lib. Shut up, lib. Hope you fucking have enjoy your 4 years of fucking destitute. Enjoy 4 years of poverty.
This is a good
enjoy 4 years of fucking socialism, you dirtbag. Man! Go occupy something.
But wait, what did Obama
occupy his mother's asshole?
What did Obama say that? Hold on, what did dude?
Because you're fucking wrong,
dude,
and you know it.
What did Obama say? What did Obama say he would do?
I stopped telling.
The Republicans said they wouldn't do.
The Secretary of State said she would not do that. It's naive to think that that's the right thing to do, going into a sovereign country and killing. He said everybody said that he was naive for doing it, and to say now that anybody would have done it is bullshit.
I thought it was great what he did.
What did he do?
He went into Pakistan without their knowing because they sucked. They're the worst allies ever.
They're a terrible country.
Terrible.
And,
terrible.
I thought it was great that they did it.
Yeah.
And it was in Islamabad, which is like their, it's a really nice neighborhood.
Yeah, George Bush wouldn't have done that. Oh, that's right. He just launched into fucking Iraq with everything. Yeah. Shut up. He wouldn't go into Pakistan without permission. Yeah, he fucking sent an army to fucking Iraq for no reason. So shut the fuck up. Shut up. Shut up and take a greedy little paws off my tax money, you cocksucker. You cocksucker. You're a cocksucker like your father. Shut up.
Sounds like me and my mother arguing.
This is what I do before sex.
I just like I could yell for 2 seconds and he just keeps going.
Here's the thing, too. You know, when they... Caught Bin Laden, which is great for my morale.
Yeah.
It's like when they put Gotti in jail, we didn't stop the mob. You know,
there's
a different figurehead.
If you're trying to say Gotti took down the towers, I'm going to smack
come
you.
On, gotta...
you know, oh, okay.
Yeah, Joe in Boston wants in. He has a lot to say. Joe.
Right.
Hey, guys. Yeah. So, Rich, just like most other Jews who live in a state of denial, doesn't seem to understand that Israel was created under false pretenses where people were booted from a land that they already lived in. A war was started immediately after it was given to Israel, and Israel just summarily got rid of
them. Well, first of all, the anti-Semitic United Nations voted that that's the homeland for Israel, okay?
Yeah,
unlike every other country that was taken, all right? America was taken.
How about post-war? There were a lot of fucking nations that didn't want to be under the Soviet Union's rule. That's what happens in the world. People are thrown out of some places. Other people get in, and then it happens again the other way around. But that's what happened. So what's your fucking problem?
Here's my problem.
All right.
The fact that Jews here and in Israel bitch constantly, oh, there's rocket attacks, and there's Hamas, and there's Hezbollah. Why do you think that happens? Like, that's fine. History is what it is. That happened. I get it. But the fact that you're wondering why this keeps happening is unbelievable.
Because they're savages that are intent on killing people based on nothing but religion.
They cut off their own women's clits, okay?
Right. Yeah.
If a woman gets raped, they kill her, okay? These are not fucking, peaceful people.
You know what? That does, I got to say, that does strengthen the argument because... Like you're saying, cause and effect. They wouldn't fire rockets for no reason. Right. It has to be a root cause.
Well, Americans are so fucking naive. They're trying to rationally think out these people's ideas for doing shit. Cause they're animals. Cause they're fucking animals.
The same group does. The same religious mentality really does. Yeah. Fucking execute rape victims.
Yeah.
I mean is hard to justify.
Okay,
so how do you make peace with these irrational people?
Right.
Okay.
This guy's saying that the whole Jewish state is an irrational.
Yeah, he's saying it's a big mistake.
Tell that to the United Nations that voted that's the state.
No one takes that
because
seriously.
Nobody else. Fucking England wouldn't take them. Yeah. France, they were kicked out of every country in Europe.
You can't blame them.
Well, then obviously, there's the problem.
Go to any. Go to,
you have some room for us.
Yes. They would like to stay.
I have my breakfast bagel and it stinks, but can I stay in your house?
This fucking guy, go to Nobel Prize winners and see how many fucking Arabs have contributed to society like the Jews have.
Oh,
okay?
You
when you're in the hospital ready to have heart surgery, who would you rather have looking down on you. So you shut the fuck up, you idiot.
Okay, yeah, shut
because
up.
Rich, you know what? You're just another fucking liberal, self-hating Jew, probably pro-Palestinian. Go fuck yourself, okay? Yeah.
Now this guy doesn't like Jews.
I was going to go pro-Palestinian, but I blew my knee out.
Can I please get a word in?
Yeah, let him get a word in.
Hey, did you get my CD yet? Did you buy my CD?
Wow.
Rich, I came to see you and took a picture with you. You couldn't have looked more miserable.
The first good point I've heard out of him.
I don't take good pictures.
Finally, a valid argument.
Why don't you take good pictures, Rich?
I don't know what
it is.
You've
been out of a long time.
Maybe that's what they need over there, more pictures together.
Where did you see me? What place?
All right. It was at...
The two places you were. Come on.
Hold on.
Exactly. Which restaurant did you see him at?
Stand Up New York or the other place?
All right. Go ahead.
I was at Vinny's. All right. So, anyway, I saw him at Vinny's place. It was a good show. I can't
Stress Factory.
Anyway.
Cousin Josh's.
Rich always puts on a good show.
You won't even recognize Vinny's Club, this guy.
Why?
Stress Factory, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
What am I giving him a plug? I'm not
No, this kid,
week.
He wouldn't even say Vinny's place. I'm like, say, you know, Israel and Stress Factory, recognize it. Go ahead.
<All right.
laughs> Sorry, Rich.
All right, go ahead. Sorry, I got...
So go ahead. You were saying Mengele is a hero.
Exactly.
I was looking at that the other day. I hate to interrupt you, Rich. But did you... You know when they caught Eichmann?
Yeah.
And, like, they had that trial in Israel? And, like, the whole time he's smiling, like, do you think it was, like, this weird thing of, like, look at these Jews putting on this trial? Like, you know, like, it's like special needs kids, like, they're playing baseball.
Like, you couldn't fathom that it's actually going to work.
Yeah, like, he's the umpire at a special needs baseball. Like, you're out. Whoa, you're a real slugger. Like, pretending they're normal and human. Sorry. I was just thinking about it because he has that weird smile the whole time. Like, look at this adorable trial by the Jews. Go ahead. I'm sorry, Rich.
No, it's on me.
Joe, your final point, please.
His name is Rich.
Yeah. So I'm not some liberal idiot. Like, I got a fucking master's degree in this shit. I studied it for 10 years, Rich. So I'm not some liberal idiot.
Well, he's unemployed.
Okay. Argue with Anthony. He's smarter.
Oh.
Well, no, like, I'm not trying to argue. I'm just trying to make a point that, like, if you don't try to see it from the other side, like, this is just going to keep history.
Yeah.
You're seeing it from the other side with eyes that cannot possibly fathom what's going on there. You're thinking, Americans think of things in terms of America, very short-sighted. How is it that you totally just throw away the fact that there's a religion over there that is based on violence, hate, overpowering the weak, women have to be uneducated and killed if they're raped because they caused it? Like, how is that looked at? And then you go, well, the reasonable reason they would do that. No. You just got to label them what they are and what they show themselves to be every day. Fucking animals.
Okay, and I mean, okay, say they have, say their conflict with Israel, why are they blowing up trains in Spain, subways
mainly
in
on
London?
The plane, though.
Yeah, exactly. You're insane.
No, wait a minute.
Too bad you don't have a brain. My interest in you will really wane. One thing you've not done in show business is gain. Silly Jew, just go ahead and complain.
Mm. A spoken word, sorry. Williamsburg style. That was very meta. Very something hipster.
Why is it everywhere they go, they leave a trail of destruction?
No,
everywhere.
They don't. That's not true.
Yeah, all these bodies are just laying.
What about when they come here? They're really hard workers and stuff. You see them like working at the delis and stuff like that. They're great.
Not the fringe, but the main.
No, we're talking.
They're not like Anthony is labeling like an entire group based on the actors.
Yep.
So few, it's ridiculous.
Yep.
Like,
so few.
Like, you used to be Anthony. You used to be a lot smarter than this. Like, what the fuck?
No, I wasn't. You were bamboozled. I've always been a fucking idiot.
Okay, but so what are you saying? What's the solution? You tell me the solution.
Sure.
Final solution.
You go back to school.
Oh, see, boy. See, there it is. It's anti-Semitism.
Whipping out the Norway in them.
Whipping out the Norway.
What's the solution? No,
like, the solution is, A, like, it should have been dealt with, like, 60 years ago. But the solution now, like, there is no solution because Netanyahu and Likud have been settling the West Bank for years to the point where you could not create a two-state solution. So he likes to just, oh, yeah, little peace agreement. Let's talk about it for years and years.
Exactly. That's true.
We're going to keep the settlements going. And now there's no way to deal with it. And then they assassinate this guy, Al-Jabari, knowing that it's going to start rocket fire.
Well, but
and then they can say, now that then they that basically is their end to start another problem in Gaza on the eve of an election cycle to make themselves look strong.
But that was
all
a
political,
super cool strike.
People are dying in the
front. So that hood go flying? The car hood?
My final point, just like if you look at these rocket attacks that are supposedly such a huge problem in southern Israel, if you look at a chart of the years of which these happen, they go flying up after every major Israeli incursion into the Gaza Strip.
Mm-hmm.
So who's fucking starting what?
Wow.
Rich, comment?
I don't know. I'll get tired, man.
No, I think.
Oh, you weren't listening?
I kind of was listening, but I just got hit me out.
Wow.
You started this.
I didn't start it. Anthony asked me my opinion.
All right, Joe.
Enough with
that. I don't know what madrasa that kid went to, but he knows his stuff.
Using their puppet fucking Iranian missiles, those motherfuckers anyway. Then with their puppet missiles.
But with the Iron Dome system.
Yes.
All right, we're going
to. Why did we pay for the Iron Dome system, by the way? That annoys me.
Why?
Because we have our own money problems. Why the fuck are we helping? And Israel's a great ally, but they have enough money to do that themselves.
Hey, look, how much money do we fucking feed into Egypt?
Exactly.
Too?
Okay. Exactly. Phenomenal point. Give them zero. I agree.
Yeah, and the pyramids. Yeah. That's all I know about it.
Right.
They're trying to build big hats for the pyramids. They think it will help tourism. They want to see it from space.
But how cool is that, that Iron Dome thing where they're like shooting down, I think, only 30%. Of the missiles, though.
Yeah.
So, but I guess that's a win.
It's great, but let Israel
do it.
They
Jewish
can afford
baseball.
It.
Why don't we talk to David, who's in Israel, our pal David. David!
Hi, good morning, Hope.
Iron Dome, where there's no wrinkled shirts.
Now, this is a real Jew right here.
What's up, dude? How's it going? Yeah, where are you?
Super Jew.
I'm in Georgia. I just got back yesterday.
What?
He was in Israel yesterday, matter of fact, right? You just got back to Jersey.
Oh, the Tel Aviv to Georgia flight? I don't...
Yeah, I called you guys yesterday, but I got disconnected. This shit has been going on for 12 years. The only time it ends up in the news is when all of a sudden Israel decides to retaliate. They've been sending rockets on and off for about 12 years. It's been going on for a very long time. Only when we finally decide to take out one of their assholes for what they've been doing to us, all of a sudden, then the world decides to go ahead and pay attention. That they've been intentionally attacking civilians. When we go after them, we immediately go after the militants over there, and we do have casualties. Israel is the only country that supports the enemies in the fact that we're supplying them with their water supply, we're supplying them with electricity. Fucking Egypt is not helping out. Lebanon is not helping out. Syria is not helping out. We're the ones giving them power. We're the ones giving them water. When they go in to attack and blow up their buildings, they drop leaflets and call them to let them know, hey, we're coming to blow your shit up. You may want to get out of here.
They can't leave, though.
There's countless videos on YouTube showing them hiding behind their own civilians. I mean, what, you're dealing with a bunch of savages. It's not that one day came in and killed one of their guys, and then all of a sudden, you know, they're retaliating with rockets. The rockets have been going on for a very long time.
No, this is Dan.
But... But the whole thing is that they have them locked down like a jail over there. So that's why the people are going a little nuts. But you're right, dude.
The way we got the West Bank, the way we got that entire area, is we were sitting in April 67. We got attacked by them. And in 6 days, we took out 3 countries. Fuck you, you lose. You come, you start.
I didn't know El Al was pumping helium into the cabin of their aircraft.
But did you know Gaza was never a part of Israel? Did you know that was like the one area that was never part of the Judea state? It was the Phoenicians, I believe, correct?
The Phoenicians.
Yeah, but I mean, look,
remember those people?
Just because
I had them in my living room.
Yeah, you can't see them because the blind.
Yeah. Yes, their motto was Phoenicians. Their motto was done. Phoenicians.
I believe it's something like that. Yes, but he's right. The guy's right. I take his side too.
David.
Yo, we left in 2006, and this is the thank you that we got.
This is the thanks
you get. That flower shop there. Do you remember that?
Yeah,
they left
terrible.
Like this whole like a rose, like a hydroponic garden there where they were making flowers. It was like a really nice gesture. And then they started shooting the rockets, and then the Israelis immediately blew
it
up.
Sure,
I think that was great.
Grenade factory. They blew it up.
Yeah, they F-16 came in a whank.
That's hilarious. Yeah, we'll take out your flowers. Yeah.
Well, what are you going to do, guys? I mean, honestly.
David, what's the solution?
I think they should cut it and turn it into like a floating island.
Oh, that'd be nice.
There you go, like a pirate, like a state owner.
David.
Rich, you're so pissed. I'm sorry, man.
I know. The place. You have to carpet bomb them and just make it one big show.
Whoa.
Or carpet bombing.
Nixon Jr. In this day and age, at a comedy club, you can't even say the word whore. I mean, come on.
It's crazy. I think the world has gotten very Muslim-centric, very Arab-centric.
Yes. Europe loves the Muslims.
It's very hard to do anything that even seems against the Muslims these days.
Europe does not love the Muslims.
No, they hate Israel. They do.
Yeah, no, look at France. They're banning France. Fucking religious headgear.
I know, but they don't like Israel, though.
They hate Israel.
Maybe they don't like Israel, but I'm saying they're not pro-Islam either.
They're making the Jews put propellers
so
on those yarmulkes.
Which is so weird, because for years Europe was so into Jews.
Yeah. Yeah, they really...
In the 20s, 30s, and 40s, they were so like... You couldn't buy a drink as a Jew in Germany. I'm sorry, Rich. Go ahead, dude. I'm slowing down your political firing line here.
I'm done.
You're done? That's it?
Yeah, I'm thinking about my
the tattoo show I'm doing Monday.
What is it?
It's a tattoo cover-up show on, like, whatever.
Oh, that's cool.
Well, they think Herbert Villachez was murdered?
You get one of yours covered up?
Yeah.
Tattoo which one?
Cover-up. I love Palestine.
No, the tribal piece up here.
What are you getting it covered up with?
Huh?
What are you getting? Are you having? You should. What are you getting?
It's up in here. They're gonna do the best cover-up artist in the country.
Why would you do that? It's like a tattoo.
Right. I don't like to tell that here.
That's a cool tattoo. Right?
What are you getting put on it?
Huh?
What are you getting put on it?
Roses across the top.
Why?
Because I don't like the fucking tattoo.
The best cover-up artist, and that's all he can do with roses.
Right.
Roses are like the easiest cover-up.
Sounds like anyone could do that.
This thing is hard to...
Here, just take your shirt off.
Take your shirt off, for fuck's sake.
Yeah,
here he goes.
Do it, Jew.
Wait till you see his abs out, Jew.
Leave that shirt in a pile. It will be returned to you later.
The showers await.
After the shower, we will return your clothing.
Bread and good work on the other side.
Rejoin the rest of your family at the family camp.
They didn't, though.
We didn't see it.
No, they didn't.
We didn't see the tattoo.
We did see
what happened with the
tattoo? It's not covered. They're doing it next week.
What are they covering? What part?
Yeah, we want to see the tattoo they're covering.
Wait, you've got a tattoo of Jesus on your back. What kind of Mexican are you?
You got like a spiky thing, Asian writing, a swallow.
It's stupid.
What is that?
What does that tattoo mean?
Tribal piece.
What tribe are you a member of?
Yeah, what tribe? Oh, yeah.
12 tribes.
Did you just pick it off the wall? You picked number 28?
It means nothing.
That's a great
tribe called the Dunces.
What are you calling? Who's talking to you?
Nothing. I'm in studio with Attell and Norton and Opie and Anthony. They don't want to be here, so it's horrible. I can't do this anymore.
We need some background music.
Yeah, I'm on the air.
So is she. Tell her. You have to tell her.
Unfortunately.
No, it's all right.
Can
I mean,
Opie's
doing crossword puzzles.
Barney.
What do you want to ask her?
I want to ask her. Yeah, put her on speaker.
Tell her about the tattoo.
Are you on speaker? Bonnie, you're on speaker.
Bonnie, can you hear us?
I'm punching out.
Yeah. All right, Dave from Israel. Hey, Bonnie, if you can hear us, Rich was telling us a story how he was trying to shove something up your pussy the other night and you weren't into it.
Kind of beverage container.
I said no.
No, I know you said no, but what was it?
It was his, I don't know, he drinks it for bodybuilding.
Cum?
You bodybuild, Rich? Yeah, David Tell. So, Rich drinks this shit because he's bodybuilding, I guess. And he's
juicing. Are you juicing?
He decided that's what his wife needed, and he snuck it into bed, and she was very aware of what was going down.
So you're trying to give it to her anally instead of orally?
No,
or?
I can't even go near her ass. There's no way. If a finger just rubs on her back of her leg, she freaks out.
Because you don't know how to take charge, stupid. Get in there.
What if you blew a horn and said rocket attack?
Yeah, just put your face in there to hide.
You mentioned that it was ice cold since it was just out of the fridge.
So are you.
Yeah, you want to shove this thing, this ice cold thing up her.
Dummy Arbuckle.
But what? So it's a performance enhancement. Bonnie, what is it? Like
it's like a tube thing.
A tube. It's like
but he thought that this would be good, a nice cold
it
tube
It looks
thing.
Like a vibrator.
Okay, well, then get her a real vibrator.
Yeah, what's the matter with you?
How'd it go down, Bonnie? How'd it go down?
What's that?
What happened?
Yeah, what happened? She's on a speakerphone.
Oh, I told her to get away from me.
What's wrong with you, Rich?
Was he being sexy about it?
He tried to be sneaky about it. I thought he bought a vibrator. I was like, why is it so cold?
Man.
Cold, much like the Jew in their mind. Figured he'd get a budget vibrator. Bonnie, do you ever get into fights with Rich over political stuff like we just did?
Do I what? Argue with him?
How much delay can it be since you're outside in the car?
She's in Tel Aviv.
There's no way you guys pay for parking.
What do you call it? Attell said, do we ever get in political fights?
Yeah, like about Israel and all that stuff.
You're on the Palestinian.
I thought you're Canadian.
Same thing.
Well, that's true.
I gotta go. You guys are losers.
Bye.
What was that about?
Why did she have to go?
She's
all right. Let's break. David Tell, you're promoting the DC Improv, right? But that's next week.
Yeah, this week is the third installment of the second season of Dave's Old Porn with Amy Schumer and Robert Kerman.
Nice.
We're watching a holiday classic on Thursday, which is Thanksgiving. Debbie Does Dallas. So.
Nice. I missed the first season.
No, I don't have your phone number.
Okay.
But you missed the first season?
Yeah, as a guest.
Oh, okay. Well, we didn't have the, you know, I didn't have any of the beheading porns, which you would have been great at. But yeah, no, I'd love to have you on, man.
All right, and then until next weekend at the DC Improv. Yep. And Rich, where are you going to be again this weekend?
I'm at Gotham this weekend, Friday and Saturday. Two shows Friday, three Saturday.
All right, we got an author coming in talking about hotels. The inside scoop on hotels is next. An expose, Heads in Beds, Jacob Tomsky.
Talking about the Israeli Hilton. Yep.
All right, where's our author?
Yes.
Day before Thanksgiving.
Jacob Tomsky is coming in.
Book looks good, man. It's called Heads in Beds, a reckless memoir of hotels, hustles, and so-called hospitality.
You know, we've been talking about hotels many times on this very program.
No, Rich.
Last time we had a discussion about the wonderful Carter here in Manhattan. I wonder if he has any information or experience on that.
It's just a hotel guy?
Yes. Hi, Jacob.
Hi, hotel guy. What's going on? You know everybody in the room. That's the very funny David Tell to your right, the very funny Rich Voss to your left, the very funny Jim Norton, and then you got me and Ant here. That you know,
and the very
and that's
Sam Roberts. You know,
just the very androgynous.
The very Sam Roberts.
You're sitting between three guys that every week pretty much stay in hotels around the country.
Oh, that's true.
Every week because we're on the road.
Yeah, the comedians. You know, they're traveling all the time.
Absolutely.
You know anything about the Carter Hotel here in New York City?
That's the one where everyone gets killed at, right?
Yes. They have a few
murders,
stories.
A lot of murders, yeah.
Murders, and then horrible conditions, very dirty. I think bed bugs, that.
Bed bugs are everywhere, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, are they literally everywhere in every hotel?
Not in every, you know, you never know. I mean, they're in cabs and movie theaters. And
shit, I don't even think about that with these filthy fucking people.
Put your jackets down, it's scary to me.
What are you talking about, bed bugs?
Yeah.
I thought you were talking about black people.
Wow.
Jesus.
Wow, Rich. You just wrecked everybody's good time. Rich
we're having a good time.
Oh, my God.
I didn't know he said that.
I just
everywhere.
Made him uncomfortable. So you don't have anything on the Carter Hotel, though?
No. Just, you know, I think people were murdering babies and whatnot.
Yeah, crazy.
That's one of them, like Times Square, like off Times Square. Like
What's the buffet like? Stuff. The Continental Breakfast?
It's actually surprisingly tasty.
It's been one of the worst hotel in, like, the city, certainly.
Holy Jesus.
Well, there's a lot worse hotels than that. Come on.
I would bet.
Yeah.
Honestly, the old school, like, Elder Lodge and shit.
Overlook. Look up the Carter Hotel on YouTube. You'll be amazed with the graffiti and the locks broken, and it's unbelievable, this place.
Today, I got a 4-star hotel today for $90 on Priceline.
Congratulations. So what's the book about there, Jacob?
It's just a memoir of my life in the hotel business. All the, you know, crazy shit I've seen from the guests, some celebrity stuff in there. And then on the back end, you know, tons of tips, especially for 4-star hotels. You know, how to get an upgrade, how to get a late checkout, all kinds of things that can happen.
It's just call and say, I want a late checkout?
Yeah, no, I'm going to say no. Say no, sir. Unfortunately, we're sold out tonight.
But why do you have to be assholes and say no all the time?
Why do they always say no?
Being an asshole is part of the job, actually.
Why? Just fucking, I want a late checkout. Everybody wants a late checkout. Yeah, you have to check in late. Why can't you leave late?
Indeed, I've heard that complaint repeatedly.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I'm going to get an early check-in today, and I know how to do it.
But why do they make it?
I got tips for all this, man. I'll tell you.
How about the smoking rules? How come there's like every hotel has non-smoking now? Like, why is that?
I know, it's ridiculous. People complain, you know, like they can smell it the room next door.
The room
everyone's got allergies and all this.
Yeah, but is it a state law or is it just like the...
No, it's property specific.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's now it's like trendy. You know, but what I would do, you know, check in, you know, have a cigarette. And then call down and complain that the room smells like smoke, and then move to another room.
Excellent idea.
There you go. That's a good one.
Continue doing that every time.
That's a good one.
But there's no advantage to them allowing you to smoke, because it's a fire hazard. Mm-hmm.
It's not going
to
make the room better.
It's going to make the furniture stink. There's zero advantage to the hotel allowing.
Right.
But what if it's Vegas and like you're a Japanese billionaire type guy and you flew in, you want to chain smoke?
Oh, Vegas,
something.
You can smoke.
You will.
Oh,
they'll let you smoke if you're a billionaire.
You can do whatever you want.
I got one of those questions that, of course, everybody thinks about with hotels when you try to check in, and they say there's no rooms available. Mm-hmm. Come on now, are there rooms?
That's a huge. That was one of my favorite lies.
Yeah.
There's nothing I can do, and there's no hotels. There's always rooms left behind, you know. And that's one of the awkward situations.
So why are you guys assholes?
Yeah. Why?
Wow, you got the book.
Between that and the having to tell everyone they can't have a late checkout. I mean,
we got to manage. You got to manage this property. I mean, it's like you've got 100 rooms,
right?
You know, and then you got 120 reservations. They'll overbook a hotel because it's about a 10% cancellation rate. So you want to? They play the numbers game, but somebody's going to get screwed and somebody's going to get walked to a hotel, and you don't want to walk. Like, let's say, you know, there's nothing available for a one-nighter because we can walk them to another hotel, put them up, and then we don't have to bring them back. So you want to make sure you have rooms for someone who's there for four nights. So there's a lot of different reasons. And then if you booked a $90 rate, you know, you're going to get walked.
You want to hear my solution to the no rooms? And it's worked many times with me. I've walked around Manhattan looking for a hotel sometimes and been like, no, sold out. And you just know they're sold out. So I go into a hotel. And it takes a little while because you really got to be adamant with this. But I give them my credit card. I go, reservation, Anthony Cumia. And they're like, and I know they ain't finding it because I don't have a reservation. But I'm adamant. I'm like, I called yesterday, made this reservation. It's very important. And they keep looking. They go, Mr. Cumia. I'm like, I have nowhere else to stay. You're going to put me up at your house? And it takes a long time because they got to go to a manager. They go in the back. Yeah. They talk. But then they've always come back and said, okay, we got something for you.
There's two good ways to do it. If you can manage to be a screamer. You can pretty much push through some walls. The other way is
why is that? Because they don't want a disturbance in the lobby.
Yeah, it's just
no one wants to deal
because
with
it.
Isn't that like a life?
They want you to go. Yeah,
you scream as hard as you can. Yes. Pretty much wherever you are in whatever situation, something's going to happen. The other way actually is tipping the front desk agent.
Really?
That's something that
works huh?
all the time.
That's something that a lot of people don't know. These are the people like tippy-tapping. They're the ones that are deciding your fate there.
I am a greasing motherfucker. I love them.
We can tell you.
Greasy. Greasy. But I'll tell you something. A lot of times when you go to hand someone something, they go, no, I can't do that. I can't. And then they're like, some kind of fucking morals when I'm trying to get a room. God damn it.
You always take care of
no morals.
The people out front. You give them 20. I've been to the Barclay or whatever. Yeah. For $75, we got four stars, and they bumped us up to a suite because we threw them fucking extra.
But what if you throw to the tip and they can't do it? Like, what if you say, hey, can you upgrade me? And you offer them money, and then they take it and go, no.
Oh, yeah, boy. Well, you know, that's pretty soulless bastard, and that happens. Yeah. But generally, because the front desk agent is not a tipped position, the fact that you give them money, like immediately I get nervous. I want to do something for you. And it's not always about an upgrade. And that's the thing that people don't realize. These rooms are all different. You know, the rooms are all the same size. Have you ever heard that? That's one of the biggest lies in the hotel business. Okay. There's always a room on the corner. There's always a room with a better view, bigger bathroom that fits a rollaway. You know, everything's perfect in certain rooms. So I can find the best room of your category. Not to mention, if anybody here likes to drink, I can go ahead and throw bottles of wine, you know, or amenities, that's when you're getting your late checkout. So the what your money can do for you through the front desk, it might not be an upgrade, but you might have no idea what this person can do for you.
What's a good tip on the front desk?
$5?
A quarter. Just throw them, flip them a quarter.
Yeah, maybe George Washington needs a little more room.
I would say, a 10's a good start. 20's quite nice.
20's nice, huh?
You know, a 50, I'll carry you up to your room if you want. I'll scoop you up.
We stayed at the Carlisle, and it was so fucking overrated. That and the other one. These are like, we have butlers come to your room.
I hate that.
Yeah.
I hate all the fanciness.
Butlers,
you know? I like where you can do your laundry. I just like, that's my favorite hotel where you can do your laundry.
Laundry room? Really?
Yeah, because I'm on the road all the time, so you get to do it. Like, these cheap ass,
I like a gentleman's hotel.
I'll tell you, when you go on the road.
You're getting your cricket bat and a cheese plate and you're on your own.
When you go on the road, like, you can either stay in town, but if you can get like a Hampton Inn Suites, you get breakfast, free high speed, free parking, a workout.
High friendly. Speed.
No, but you get everything, and it's so much better than being in town at a dumb
Free cable.
It's free HBO. Exactly. What is it, 1980?
Free electricity.
Salt and
yeah.
pepper.
And the pool, they clean it.
No, I'm telling you, I go on the road all
we
the time.
We have color TV.
Cool. So what's the dirtiest thing in a room? Like, I know we know the duvets
your
are.
Balls.
Yeah. I like to call it the bedspread. Do you wash those things or what?
You know, you got the duvet cover and they're going to wash that, but the feather inside of it,
yeah,
that's not too often washed. And that'll suck up some fluids.
That's
very gentle.
Yeah, and then if you're in like a budget motel with that scratchy blanket that they try to hide between two sheets, that thing's disgusting. And another thing people don't know, the minibar glasses.
Yeah.
Right? The housekeepers are responsible for cleaning that. If you look at a minibar, if you look at a housekeeper's cart, there's no dish soap on that cart. So they're cleaning it with whatever they can, which is going to be...
Tears.
Which is going to be...
the tears of their...
See, that's going to leave spots. You cry on a glass, it's going to have, you know, cry spots on it. So they'll use shampoo, they'll use...
Why can't they have a little dish soap?
That's
I don't know, man. Maybe What's they should start. Maybe that's my mission.
I never use them. Dish soap. Never drink out of those glasses because they're dirty.
They clean them with Pledge. I cleaned it all the time. Yeah. It leaves a spot-free glass. It just it's
Pledge.
So how did you get it? Did you go to like one of these hotel management and whatever schools?
No.
You didn't do any of that.
I started parking cars.
Okay, so you worked your way up the whole ladder of hotel.
Now you got a book.
Can you get a lot of pushy working behind Hendry. The counter? Can you get a lot of pushy like from the ladies coming in by themselves or?
Pushy, what do you mean?
Pussy is a thing when a guy... Like,
oh, pussy. Yeah, oh, yeah.
I have a speech
impediment. Oh, yeah, that I thought you said pushy, and I was like, I got some pushy ladies in my face.
No, but I mean, do guys, like, do they offer you sex, like, late at night?
Yeah, you the lonely trophy wife. You
there's
know,
one, is
really?
One, is one from Canada.
Especially the bellmen. The bellmen are getting laid. Up in them rooms.
Really?
Really?
What about the maids? They hook on the side?
No, I remember that. I don't think so. They're too busy working hard, man. That job is difficult.
That is, that's an unforgiving job, isn't it?
Why is it difficult?
You know, I worked...
Trying to figure out how to get the cum out of the sheets? How do you get cum out of the sheets?
I think you just, you know, burn
them. Watch him. Protein gets out protein. I saw
what's
that on.
The weirdest?
You just throw it in the washer. It takes itself out.
Nice.
What's the weirdest, like, late night, like, somebody calls up, hey, do you got a, you know, something, like a banjo and a something? Like, anybody? Well,
you know, I had a celebrity. This was actually, I was in New Orleans. I was a housekeeping manager at the time. And had a celebrity. He was in town filming a movie. Famous actor. And
Brad Pitt.
No. And he was, I'm going to say no to whatever he said.
Was this during the show, Tremol? Can I get some gumbo and a... Saxo, look at that disgust in your face. I'm sorry.
What do you got?
No, but this guy,
celebrity.
This guy, he is a super freak, man. He had bags of pills in his room, like, and I'm not talking fun pills.
That limits it down.
I'm not talking fun pills. Yeah. I'm talking like nutritional pills, like a bag, like I couldn't even stomach it. And he asked for we had these big silver potpourri bowls, and he calls down. And he wants five of them. And so I hustle, I steal them from rooms. He said he wanted to eat cereal out of them, and these things are gonna fill a whole. The whole box, you could dump it in. He also asked for like an acupuncturist and a voodoo doctor, and a therapist, all at the same time. Like it was an emergency. He calls down. He's like, "We need
a
voodoo doctor now."
What year was this?
That was like 2001. He's still
what
still
movies came
out
in,
still out there
based
doing
in New Orleans, Muhammad Atta. Right.
Yeah,
you might have given away the celebrity.
Yeah.
What movie came out around 2001, 2002?
Space Oddity.
Based in New Orleans.
That was just because he was in
Space Oddity.
You got that one wrong.
That's because he was in New Orleans, though.
I have another question. I've always been very curious about with hotels.
Sure.
Obviously, you unwrap that nice soap. You use it for 2 seconds. You pop it up there. It would seem a horrid waste for the hotel to throw all those away, but you can't just leave them in there. What the fuck happens with the unused soap? Go.
You melt it down and remold it, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah,
leaving the
puke sir. Yeah, we just carve it down to a smaller soap.
That's
you know,
it.
But no, all that's thrown away. Those little, it's kind of sad. They especially even those empty shampoo bottles, little tiny jobs.
Yeah.
You take like half of it. It's like a rule in a luxury hotel. There's usually like there's a symbol for the hotel. And if it gets below that symbol, then you have to replace it.
Yeah,
you know,
but
to make sure it's full, and it's just they're just throwing that away.
Yeah, but that hotel shampoo, I mean, you never like leave a hotel and go like, where can I pick that up? It's always some like weird.
You'd be surprised, man. I used to laugh my ass off when guests would be like, your mattresses are fabulous.
Oh,
like,
really?
What mattress is this? I'm like, I don't know damn mattress is.
Some of those things on top of the mattress in some hotels are the most comfortable.
The pillow tops.
Some of
them,
I've been to some of them that were so fucking comfortable.
Yeah.
That I don't have an answer.
That's usually what it is. It's not that it's a Serta Sealy Plus. Yeah. It's
not to interrupt Rich's trip down comfortable memory lane. I wanted to throw in an interesting fact, too. Like, one time I was in this hotel and the TV was just crisp. See how awful it is? You said it one the article, I think, in the Post that they... people, they actually come in and really look through your shit? Like, they actually do that?
Do they?
Sure. I mean, well, you know, when you start working at the hotel, you know, it's like real voyeuristic, man. I see you going out, and, you know, we all have master keys, man. Any room, anywhere, anytime. And looking through your shit, that's not bad. It's when we start fucking with your shit that it really gets dirty.
Oh, man.
You know
what I mean?
How do they fuck with your stuff?
You know, you can... things done to toothbrushes.
No way, really?
I'm sorry, yes.
Is that true or is that...
I've never done that.
That's an urban legend.
Why would they do that? Just like as a...
Yeah, if you were a prick, you know, you make a...
Nicolas Cage, what?
Yeah, you scream at somebody, you make like a racist or homophobic comment, or you know, you yell at...
I better hide my toothbrush.
I'm going to screw you. You yell at... Like, people yell at me, yelling at the doorman in front of me. And I'm like, that's my boy right there. That's my friend. Don't yell at my friend. I'm going to screw you.
Oh, man.
You call him your boy.
He's my boy. He's
rich. It's like Bad Boys the movie.
How about you guys just mind your own business?
Take all the... Yeah, what about the ice machine? I mean, is that normal? I mean, like, what is that?
It's a machine that produces...
No, I know, but, like, there's all the beginning. Time. Do you guys ever, like, clean that out, or, like, I mean...
Yeah, I don't think you're going to have any problem. You know, all these, you know, I don't think you're going to have any problems with the ice machine there.
Yeah,
maybe the bucket. You know, the bucket's probably pretty gross.
Yeah. Okay.
Hey, why don't you ask about the soda machine?
Yeah, what about the soda machine?
You know, I have to go to Coca-Cola if I...
No, I figured, and also the hotel pool, like, I feel like it's very un... first of all...
every pool, right?
Yeah, it's like just, like, filthy for some reason. Even, like, in a big hotel, whatever, unless it's outdoors.
Who goes into a pool? That's disgusting.
Yeah.
You smell a lot of chlorine in hotel pools. Yeah. You know, it's...
hotels, you gotta... You take all the blankets off, you lay under one sheet, and you just turn the heat up. You fucking... Don't touch. You put your fucking... channel thing in a plastic bag.
Or a sock.
No, just use it. Who cares?
Sleep in the tub. That's
let me tell you something. If you get in that tub, is one of the worst things you can do in a hotel is to take a bath in that fucking disgusting, jizz stained hepatitis tub.
You ever stay in a nice room?
Huh?
Who's doing Jesus. That in the tub?
What if you're handicapable and that's your only way?
Yeah. Yeah. Fucking the tub.
I stay in very nice hotels.
Nice hotels. The tub is like fucking great.
Yeah, that's one of the hardest things to clean too, man. Sure. Cleaning that tub is so...
I never use it, but it's always fucking...
Well, you can see that.
You know, like crime scene cleanup people, and I'm sure you've had them in your hotel.
And yeah.
We did a thing with me on the Insomniac thing years ago, the guy told me that if you ever go in a hotel and there's like carpet, like the carpet doesn't match, that usually means there was either blood. Or some other kind of thing, and they cut it out and they just put it in new carpet. Is that true? Or?
Yeah, absolutely. There was a situation we had where a kid had rented a room. His father was rich, and his father couldn't get in touch with him, so he called the hotel. He was concerned, and you know, I talk about this in the book a little bit. And he comes up, and the security opens the door, and this kid is covered in blood. He'd been cutting himself like, all day. The robe was open. He was totally dazed. He was on drugs, and there was blood all over the hotel room, and they had to have crime scene come in, and it was like a $20,000 cleanup. No, he didn't die. He didn't die. He was totally dazed.
Did they charge him for the cleanup at least?
Yeah. They charged his daddy for the cleanup.
They put it on their bill.
Yeah.
And when are you guys going to update the laundry thing? I mean, trousers and top hats and all those different crazy Titanic things, bowler hats.
Yeah.
Slave leash.
Yeah. I mean, I'm always trying to do a joke on it, but it's like really weird. Trousers and...
Yeah, those tails.
The irons. I'm about to get a cape laundered here.
And the fucking irons that are attached to the ironing board.
Fucking,
who's going to really steal an iron?
Do people steal everything?
Everything,
man.
Yeah.
They will steal everything.
I was staying in a hotel and they stole the batteries out of the remote control.
Hell yeah.
That is like, that is ghetto. Yeah.
That's grimy.
That
That's grimy.
And they is a word for you know who.
So,
people that need batteries.
Yes, battery thieves. So bed bugs, how many hotels have them? Because we check the bed bug registry before we go to a hotel.
I've heard that.
It's actually pretty good.
What's up with the bed bugs? Yeah, what can you tell
us? Well, you know, like I had this situation with this lady. You know, first of all, I've had these people come down and they're like, look at... This is a bed bug bite. This has got to be it. And I'm like, I'm not a goddamn doctor, man. I don't know what that is. It looks like, you know, you a mosquito bite, I don't know. But and they'll bring down little bugs and bags and like forensic evidence.
They bring
stuff.
It in with them, probably get a free ride.
Yeah, whatever. But you know, I got into this one lady because she was like,
"Oh, nice."
She was like, "You have bed bugs here. This is a you guys are on the bed bug registry. Yeah. Like, how do I know you don't have bed bugs?" And I was like, "Look. How do I know you don't have bed bugs, ma'am? You just traveled in a cab.
Wow!
You know, you were just in an airplane, right? You know, these little guys are international, man. They're jumping about. So don't bring bed bugs into my hotel, please. You
That's
know?
How you nice. Really answered that?
No, I said I'm.
That's what he wanted to say.
Like, wow.
No.
Because it's been a ripe up there. Yeah.
But usually,
did you feign that you were from like Poland? And go like me, Like they always do with me. They never speak the known language. Of
Usually, a 4-star hotel won't have bed bugs, right?
Yeah, I mean, they do.
That's not true.
What'll happen?
They're a little cleaner.
What'll happen is it's going to happen in one room, and then what you do is they shut down that one room, and then if you find out that your room did have bed bugs, obviously that's going to get comped, and then they'll shut down the rooms to the left. To the right of it, and they'll bring someone in, and then they'll fix it. So it's not going to be the entire hotel. It's going to be one room, and then they're going to clear out the rooms around it, and it'll be fine.
But what if they don't know? Like, what if one of them hops on the maid cart and they start spreading?
Yeah,
little bed bug babies.
What's working there?
Good point.
It's a ballet. Dudes, these bed bugs.
Well, here's a question, which is like, I think I've seen a lot of hotels that were haunted or was said to be haunted, like Austin and Boise, Idaho. Like they have these like legendary haunted hotels. Have you ever had that experience? I mean, you're there all night long. In
It gets kind of spooky.
So has there been ever like that kind of thing?
I mean, I don't really believe in that kind of stuff. But I mean, when you start thinking about all the people who have murdered each other and died and killed in suicide, I had this one guest who, his sister, murdered herself in the room.
That's suicide.
And then he came back and he only wanted to stay in that room.
Wow.
And it was really weird. Creepy. Yeah, and it used to make me sad.
Wow.
But late night, you never know. It's a spooky place.
Because I was in a hotel one time and like people were coming down going like, I can't sleep. There's something horrible, you know, blah, blah, blah.
Hold on, let's go back. I want to go back to that story. Do you ever tell the guy, sorry, but that room's taken tonight?
Yeah, there was a situation he would call and he'd be like, can I have, you know, room 1227?
Yeah, sorry. Like, someone else has it.
Someone else is using that room for suicide. That's
what happened in room 237.
1227, that's a haunted room now.
I understand that.
That movie will be haunted.
Wow. By the way, great.
Yeah.
Thing here, you're talking about somebody who you worked with, I guess, who said he learned how to diffuse guests' anger. Because guests would, if you're too meek and sympathetic, that will fuel their anger. Or if you throw back your shoulders, it seems unsincere. But he said he would one-up their anger. Like if a guest came back from lunch and said, I came back from lunch, my room hasn't been cleaned, anyone planning on cleaning it? That the guy would, Andy would go, what?! I can't believe they failed to clean. And then angrily push the buttons and one-up your anger.
They can't do anything at that point.
And then it makes the customer's defensive.
You're
like, that's
just
all right.
As mad
like,
as
no,
they
it's,
are.
It's okay. It's okay, sir. You know, nobody, but that somebody's going to be fired over this. And they're
unsympathetic, that phony... I'm sorry, I can't. That does make me angrier.
Drives you nuts, right?
You gotta know how to deal with it.
I do apologize, sir, for any inconvenience. That insincere company line apology makes me sick.
I mean, I got good at the front desk of gauging people. You know, I could tell by the time you entered the lobby what type of person you were and how you wanted to be treated. You know what I mean? If you wanted the professional service, I'm going to give it to you. If you wanted me to be, you know, relaxed, cool, make jokes, fine. You know, I got kind of.
And what about the hot cookie? Like, why is that? Like, when did that become the big thing? You know, like when people check in.
Is that a thing? Hot cookies?
Yeah, like you go to a hotel and they go,
that's at the Hampton Suites.
Yeah, they give you a hot cookie and a bottle of water so that your whole day's meal. Looking for jobs.
I came here, I didn't get any hot cookies.
That's true.
All right, dude. Well, I'm just saying, you know, I'm sorry.
Oh, here's another thing. And this front desk guy, a lot of people have thought of this. I use a computer. I got my little mouse. I point and click. I can find anything in the world. It's very simple. Why the 8,000 keystrokes? You're looking.
Yeah.
It's like, I got a reservation. Here's my credit card. Click, click, click.
And then back to this again. Yeah. What the fuck are you doing?
Well, I got two things. I became a supreme hustler at that front desk. And sometimes when you're trying to extract a tip for an upgrade, I would fake type all the time to make it look like I was working. I already got your room, right? But I'm just sitting there like, hold on, sir. I'm just like tippy tappy. Because it makes you look like you're working. But actually, I mean, these systems are there's a lot of training that goes on there. They're very complicated. And what they're doing is swapping your room out because you got 500 rooms, 300 of them are dirty. They're coming back all the time. You're blocked in a dirty room and you've got all these requests. So I've got to find another room from another guest, swap that out, replace that guest room, make sure everyone has a room and all the holes are filled.
Oh, God.
So there is a lot of work going on.
Point and click, motherfuckers.
Here's another thing.
I see you hit that goddamn return key 8 times once. Yeah. I don't know what that was all about.
How come room service takes like an hour and a half? Like, why is that?
Oh, man. Oh, you know, that's one.
Like, even you order like the most basic thing. Like, oatmeal. You know, just give me what you're
like
eating.
A Diablo sandwich and a Dr. Pepper.
Snap it.
It does take a long time. You know, that's one of the, in the book, that's one of the tips. You know, oftentimes you can, and it's, of course, overpriced, and then it's going to come
cold. Absolutely. Yeah.
So you can actually order delivery in the area, and then, you know, wonderful restaurants are going to deliver, right? And then you can call room service and ask them for the plates. So just like if you want to have your little fancy silver dish,
I'm not going to do that.
Get them to send that up and then put your, outside delivery. But they're going to deliver that
food.
Your
Domino's pizza on top of it.
Yeah, but then when I leave the room, they're going to just take my toothbrush and shove it up their ass. I learned that.
Well, they don't care. The housekeeper don't care. If you don't care, right?
That's why I don't brush my teeth.
It's a good plan.
Back to the ice machine.
Wait, I got a question for you.
He soaks them every night.
After I leave here, I'm checking into my hotel, and I got to get in early.
Sweet.
So I'm just going to walk in with a sob story. Look, please.
Yeah, give Rich a sob story. Let's see if this works.
What can Rich do?
A slob story.
It's a biography. You already did the 20 bucks. Sob story.
Here's the thing.
Billy Bob Thornton was the guy.
Right? Yeah. And I know there's available rooms because people check out.
Sure.
So there's a clean room.
Yeah.
I haven't forgotten.
So should I offer him 10 or 20?
None of those two guys.
10 or 20. Here's an even better tip for that, actually. If you call ahead, if the room, if the hotel was 60% occupancy last night, that means 40% of the rooms are actually clean in the morning, and people who are coming in super early were giving out those rooms.
Yeah.
So if you call ahead, if you had called this morning and said, you know what, I just got out of the airport, I'm on my way, can you pre-register me into a ready suite?
Hey, fuck that. Let's do it right now.
Well, no, but see, I did Priceline, so the hotels hate Priceline.
All right, call them up.
But still, no, when you're calling,
Rich, we got an expert right now. Let's do it. Let's see if this shit works.
Call them up.
We'll sell a lot of books if this works. Heads in Beds is the name of the book we're talking about by Jacob Thompson.
I'll do this, but the reason I don't like doing it, because if they say no now, then I'm screwed when I get there.
What should I say? Call the hotel. Let's do this.
Let me find.
Just say, I don't know if there's
let
a
me find any... the number.
Oh boy.
Can we still talk while he's doing it?
Yeah.
Now, bed and breakfast on the scale of one to gay, where is that in your world of like, what do you think of that whole experience, bed and breakfast?
The funny thing is, you know, as I've been working in hotels my whole life, which allowed me very little time to actually stay in them.
I know, but you must know people on the other side of the business.
I did one stay in one
they're
bed.
They're all swingers,
and breakfast.
Right?
Yeah.
And hoping for some action,
right? It's a creepy vibe. Yeah, they're like, breakfast
I mean, the owners.
Is at 7.
Fuck that. I want to walk around the room, throw my clothes anywhere I want, fucking eat when I want, leave that shit all over the place.
Yeah.
And then when I'm in the shower, I don't give a shit. Like, at home, you know, you rinse out and wring out your washcloth. Mm-hmm. After scrubbing your ass crack, that thing gets swacked against the wall.
Yeah.
Fuck it. And I don't want a bed and breakfast where I got to worry that I'm going to... You know, embarrass myself in front of somebody. Fuck
you guys see the same people, like all the, the couple, and then they're, retarded kid who works lives in the garage.
Right.
in Europe, all the hotels have like a free breakfast. I mean, you know, are you kidding me? The ones in
England?
Holland? In Holland, not England. You might remember, like, Rich, he doesn't have a book out, but he runs a website called worstfacts.com.
You can work anywhere in the country or in the world now because you have that experience. And like, have you like gone like the third, like, you know, whatever, like the Ramada and, you know,
like international travel. I mean, when I did that, you know, I was obviously shoestring, you know, I've been, you know, poor.
What's up with the pillows?
Do you get offended when somebody like him walks in with their own pillow into like saying your
pillows?
It's
sort of, it's not a good look.
I know.
You know, pillows.
I don't walk in with my own pillow.
Yeah, hotel pillows.
Kenny carries it.
Yeah. Plus, those pillows are nice.
I heard you checked out of a hotel on the road because you didn't like the pillows. No, here's what I do. I'm a bad sleeper to begin with, and
By sleeper, he means person.
And a human to go with.
Yes. By sleeper, I mean fuck. I'm a quick, lousy sleeper. But the thing is, I can't. A lot of the sheets are itchy, like in the Westin.
Yeah.
I cannot.
Why are they itchy?
They just drive my skin crazy.
Overwashing. Bleach. I mean, you wash something. I mean, imagine.
Oh, right,
they're
yeah.
stiff. Wash. Courtyard by Marriott. I sleep in those fuckers. The sheet, whatever their bedding is it's a corporate decision because the bedding is just comfortable for me. I've checked out of 5-star hotels to go to a Courtyard because I sleep better. I cannot sleep in a fucking Westin. I wish I could. Dude, I can't
nudge.
My skin's very sensitive.
All right, so I'm going to call them. Are you going to talk or me?
No, you're going to do it.
You talk.
See if you can pull this off. Right, use the term pre-register. If there's any available rooms, I'd love to be pre-registered.
Okay.
And don't tell them you'll be there. Tell them you're on your way.
Yeah.
Because the important thing is that they want to take care of you. You're already it's 9:30.
And don't say what hotel it is.
When's Skyfall going to be on the movie selection?
available now.
Still in theaters.
Don't say price. Make sure you tell me about
I got a great tip.
Don't use an action.
Hello, is this the front desk? Hi. May I have the front desk, please? Why, thank you.
There you go. It's nice right there.
Good question. Good start.
You got to phase two. Pre-register, remember.
Yes. You cunt.
I want to pre-come, I mean.
who's going to do it?
This poor front desk agent.
Let him get through.
Let him get the name out.
We got to let him get through this.
They're letting you ring hard, dude. They're staring at that phone ringing like, I'm not getting
it. They can't get my number, can they? My number doesn't go
through. No, they can't get it. No,
you can't get it, Rich. Relax.
You already got my number, do they?
Yeah.
You're calling from here. It's fine.
Why do you care? Oh, there you go.
Hi, how you doing? Listen, I just flew in, and I really need to pre-register and check in early, if that would be possible.
Give me your name, stupid.
Oh, you do have rooms available.
Tell me your name.
Can I give you my name so I know when I get there that you'll have it ready?
What is the last name?
V as in Victor, O-S. Voss. V-O-S.
Richard?
Yes.
And make sure that room is ready, bitch. Make sure that fucking room is ready, you bitch. I'll be there, you cunt. Make sure that ready is fucking room.
He fell for it. He ran out.
He got caught up in his headphones. He couldn't get out of the room.
He almost strangled himself. He almost strangled himself.
He couldn't get out of the room. He ran out of the room and got tangled in his headphones. That dope.
Oh, is that
almost
hilarious?
Almost tripped into the door.
He tried so hard to cover the phone up. Wow. Well, you know, that worked.
But why would he fall for that?
That worked.
Yeah. So, yeah, pretty good. It was good that he went that one step farther and said, you know, just if you could, just I want to make sure to pre-register. Last name.
Rich, were you panicking a little?
You're in? Good to go.
Yeah.
Not only that.
So give him a tip.
She said, give a tip. I already saved on the tip. I'm in. Now
give him a tip.
Oh. Yeah, I'll take that. I'll take money. You know what? Another thing to do at that point, now what you've done is you've dealt with a really nice front desk agent who took care of you. Remember their name. Write their name down.
Oh.
And then when you get there, now you have a contact. And you're like, you know what? I spoke to you this morning on the phone. You helped me out. Thank you so much. And then that's a good point to give a gratuity. But also, now you have a personal contact. And she's like, I did help you. And now you're not just, you know, like a discount-seeking guest. You're like a nice guy that called in a personal
She'll put the kilo of Coke in your bag when you leave.
Sweet.
Listen
better
to
than
me.
Warm cookies.
Listen to me, book peddler. I don't give a shit.
I got
my fucking room. Go fuck yourself. I'm done with you.
Why so mean? Rich, he helped you.
Rich,
what's up, man? You all right?
Rich is abrasive.
I got yelled at my whole life. I got a thick skin.
Yeah, right. How are you going to shock him?
I'm going to tip her when I walk in.
That's a kind thing to do. She sounded very
nice. I just learned something.
What?
Hotels don't have a 13th floor, so this book doesn't have a 13th chapter.
Consistency.
Are people really superstitious?
Wow.
People are dummies, aren't they?
Yeah, it's true, though. He doesn't have a 13th chapter.
You know, the fear of the number 13 is called triskaidekaphobia.
You don't have a 13th strand of hair.
Well, you won.
That's just mean-spirited.
I don't understand.
Why are you attacking poor Opie?
Yeah, what the fuck?
I thought Jimmy was on Rich's page when he quoted that.
What are you eating?
I'm eating turkey chili.
Wait, what did I...
It's not too shabby.
It looks delish.
Wait, what did I say? I was on Jimmy's page.
Triskaidekaphobia. You know, useless fucking information.
Voss's
Voss's pig.
What do you call it?
What?
Triskaidekaphobia. Autism. I think we've all learned that.
Yeah. But the, but the hotels do have the 13th floor. It's just not called the 13th floor.
He's giving Rich shit.
I know.
He's like, yeah, look, we all know that. Let's move on, Rich.
So when you're in town, like, where do you stay? I mean, like, you must be like a pariah, like the Salman Rushdie of the hotel world.
Well, you know, I stay in my apartment. You know, I live in Brooklyn here. But, you know, I'm going to do some traveling. You know, I'll be in... New Orleans for, you know, book tour in Asheville. So I'm very excited to stay in these hotels. And, you know, I hope one of the things I did in Heads and Beds is really just accentuate the struggle of all the positions. So I'm really hoping that any, you know, hotel workers out there listening, they really like what I've done, you know.
They're going to be able to relate.
You know, it's definitely more, it's a worker.
That's your ball. Yeah. You ever watch those videos where the maid walks in and the guy's like jacking off on the bed.
Word.
And
he hides the camera. I've been in that video.
Yeah. Those are hilarious. Oh. The guy's like jacking off on the bed and he sets a camera up and leaves the door open and takes the do not disturb sign off. And he's just jacking off. And eventually the maid comes in and he gets her on video going like, oh, and shutting the door. It's fucking hilarious.
I can't wait to see it.
It's great. There's a bunch of them.
You got whores in your book.
There's a lot of dirty business.
We haven't talked about the whores.
I was,
nice.
Bring your own whore, you call it.
Yeah, BYOW.
What's that mean?
BYOW.
Well, that hotels are the brothels of today. It's just now, it's just a, you know, bring your own whore situation.
Right.
Like you rent a room, you know, you got a lot of businessmen, you know, actually business people that, you know, they live in Connecticut. And then they get a room for the week in New York because they're working, you know what I mean? They want to be close. But all they use that is like, you know, like a whore palace.
And then they got the internet to get the girls from.
Absolutely.
So now you got your home base.
Do you know when the whores are coming through the lobby?
Some of them are quite obvious, you know, and then you got the subtle ones. But really what the best thing that they can do is all they need is a room number. You know what I mean? Mm. They don't need anything else. So it's only a bad whore would come to the desk and ask where she's going. Because it's just, you know, it's like her first day on the
dummies.
Job or something. Usually they'll have a room number. So they just go straight up. So, you know, it's very, very subtle.
When a girl comes in and she's tall and she has an Adam's apple, will the desk clerk know what comedian she's going to see?
Jimmy's long explanations of the obvious. Yes.
Oh,
that's,
you know,
great.
I wasn't sure which comedian during the
of course you are.
During the hurricane.
Well, what are you looking for? Umbrellas?
We supposed to have
them. It's windy.
Hotel rooms on Priceline were $1,000 to $4,000 a night.
That's crazy.
Yeah. There were price gouging. Now, that's against the law,
though.
I mean, during that hurricane, they were $1,000 to $4,000.
The Attorney General in New York is going after people on Craigslist who are doing that, and hopefully in Jersey. Mm-hmm. I think Chris Christie doesn't probably tolerate that shit either.
But they were every hotel in New York up New York prices to $1,000.
Interesting fact about that kind of situation, any kind of storm, you actually have to lodge the hotel workers in the rooms as well, because they can't travel. All the trains are down, so some of the rooms are taken up by the staff. You need to run the rooms. I used to do that all the time. They'd put us in a room. We'd party so hard, man.
So if you walk in and they say, it's a storm, and like they say, it's $2,000 a night now. Are they legally allowed to do that? And what's your recourse if you walk in and you know they're price gouging? It's not a $50 difference. It's
I'm a front desk agent. I'm not a lawyer. I don't know.
Okay,
it sounds illegal. It sounds like bullshit. But okay. I don't know.
Say you're already in there.
I mean, as a business owner, it seems legal, right? I don't know.
No, but say you're
price gouging. There's a certain thing with price gouging where
when is it a commodity? Like gas, you can't do it, but like a hotel room, a place to live, seems like a commodity. I don't know.
I don't know
it's
what the
interesting
law is.
Question, actually.
I bet you could raise the fucking price,
but if
another hotel has a cheaper rate, you go there. But if there's price fixing, there's probably an issue.
Then again, they do it during the parade, along the parade routes. There's huge
New
Year's Eve.
Huge prices
jacked. Yeah, exactly. For views, you change the rates.
Yeah, New Year's Eve, the rate goes way up. Yeah, that's an amazing thing about hotels is like the same room the night before could cost you twice as much the next night.
Absolutely.
With no difference in the fucking room. It makes no sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, but say you're in the
hotel. Based on availability, it's like a math equation. You know, as the percentage of hotel goes up, 65, 75, 85, the rates start to go up because the rooms are at a premium.
What is your opinion?
You're stuck in there, a storm comes, and you can't get out. You were there for $100 or $200 a night, then you can't get out of town, and now they're $2,000 a night. What the fuck? What's your recourse?
You can't get out of the hotel?
Yeah, why? Is it that windy?
No, because there's nowhere to go. There's nowhere to go.
They don't care.
He's already hunkered down, and
they don't care.
He's going to stay there.
Well, now you know how a fucking Palestinian feels, you Jew.
Do I really?
They have no reservations.
Nowhere to go. They're kicked out of the place.
Yeah, see? They can't, the little soaps.
Yeah, but they never paid for the original night there.
Wow.
But what about
and they'll never use the soaps.
Now, have you ever worked on a cruise ship, which is more of a, like Boston a sea hotel?
I was really close. I heard that's a great gig, man, because it's like, you know, I'm sure it gets pretty wild on a cruise ship. You work long hours, but your room and board is taken care of. Mm-hmm. And then you're visiting these stops and all that. When they pay you at the end. So it's like they dump you off back on your own shore and then just like give you a ton of money. I always wanted to do that.
That sounds cool. Yeah.
Yeah. I was this close, you know, but I never went that way.
But they probably have it like locked down. Because like you said,
I would think the 12 whole staff on, 12 is off. Just banging each other.
Anything else about the book? Anything we missed in the book there, sir? You want to mention?
A ton of.
I wanted to ask something.
Anything else you want to mention?
Yeah. Well, back to the movies. You know, there's some information in there about how to steal if you guys are interested.
Wow. You're really giving up the whole. That's cool, man. That's really important.
For example,
movies are like $15 a pop in hotels.
Yeah. Absolutely, and that's a subscription service that the hotel pays, right? So it's not. It's like they don't lose any revenue, and those things cut off all the time.
Yep.
They freeze in the middle. So if you enjoy your movie, you know, and enjoy Skyfall, whatever you're talking about, and then just call down and be like, you know what, I ordered the wrong movie. It cut off in the middle. You know, it froze, whatever you want to say, and it's going to come off, and that's at no loss of revenue for the hotel. Same thing for the minibar.
How do you get out of park?
Really, minibar?
Wait, the minibar, they don't lose anything?
No, they do, but I mean, you got M&Ms, you're paying $7.
Yeah, you can replace them with your own. I do that sometimes.
Yeah. Or just say you didn't have it. I mean, that's the thing. That's the most disputed that charge.
What about the pressure-sensitive ones, though?
Oh, I've screwed that up sometimes.
There's so many. The minibar system is so fallible that, you know, you put your sandwich there, you're looking at an item, you get charged, that I spend all morning removing these charges. So essentially, if you actually did, you know, have a vodka out of the minibar and then you say, you know, I never had anything, it's going
to
get
like playing operation. You're trying to pull one out from the back there and get it around the other things. It clinks off of it, and you're paying for that too.
I replace it with fruits and juices because I think that should be more.
Attaboy, Dave.
I got a bag of sand. I got a bag of sand like Indiana Jones.
Whore binge.
Dump it on my tomato juice.
Yeah.
Three-day Coke and whore binge.
Yeah.
Needs an apple.
I take the cookies out and put in celery. They'll thank you later.
A little note, a poem, a homily.
What about? Let me ask you. What is
the Bibles? Get to it.
What do you think is the best hotel in the city? Like, just an opinion.
I mean, again, you know, I don't stay in as many as I would like.
But just from what you know about it.
I don't know, man. Let's say I'll just go ahead and throw the Waldorf Astoria, even though I've never been in
Waldorf.
I don't know.
Presidential suite at the Waldorf, pretty sweet.
Is it nice?
And sweet, yes.
What's the one I stayed in where they had art studio downstairs, Kramer Art Studio? It's like one of those with a butler.
I wish it was the MGM in the 80s.
Is that what you wish?
Can't you stay with a photographer friend? I don't know. It's New York.
Burnt down and killed a bunch of people.
What about the Bibles?
What about them?
Are they ridden with bedbugs and also a hate? I mean, honestly, what's going on with them?
Yeah, I don't know.
I mean, where are those Bibles made? Are they made by blind children in North Korea?
The Gideon. Yeah, those are free, actually. Those are provided when I was in housekeeping.
You could take those?
I had to reorder. Oh, of course. They would love for you to take a Bible, man.
Steal a Bible?
It's not. No, in a hotel Bible, it says, I believe it says, take this. Yeah, the Gideon Society, I've had to order them.
They'll send you as many as you want.
I personally think they should replace the Bibles with this book on hotels here.
Oh, man.
Wow. Shit.
Yep.
Hard.
Yeah, well, it's very interesting because this is a book I really want to read because I'm in them every weekend.
Fuck yeah.
And the bed bug thing, how do you check for bed bugs real quick? Like, I know you look on the bed, but is there a fast way to check? Or where would the hotel check if they heard there was bed bugs?
Fine comb through your pubes.
Bend over, spread him. He's got the flashlight in his mouth.
Yeah. That's funny you said pubes. Sign. What is it, 1992?
Oh, that's
Who has
true.
Those? I'm the smooth cock McGillicuddy. It's my nickname. It's my fucking screen name on AOL.
Checks in under.
Yeah. Yeah. What, if the hotel, if someone called down and said, "Sir, there's bed bugs," where would the hotel check first?
In the fucking bed, stupid.
No, they wouldn't. Oh, that's Rich. Not true, Rich.
They go hiding.
And
the behind the headboard or where would
they hang out?
What they're going to do is they're going to call an outside company because you know that's going to have to. There's professionals that do that. Sure. Hotel people aren't trained, but I do know that it is on the bed, and if you pull the sheets up, you know the edge of a mattress?
Yes.
That little lip crease. They chill into that little outside lip, and if you can see them there kind of riddled in that little
Bugs or redness from like the crushed ones that were bleeding or their own shit.
Have you seen
stuff.
Them?
Yeah.
No, I've never seen them.
I can't wait to get
I have a question. If you kill yourself in a hotel, do you still get charged? Like, will that
Absolutely.
Go on your card?
No, wow. I don't know. That's how you really check
that
out.
That's a good goddamn question.
I would still go with yes, man. I'm still gonna, you know,
that
I'm still gonna think the
heartless thing ever.
You stay, you pay. That's
it's a heartless business. That's the rule. It's a heartless
hotel. Is there a guy like that at every hotel? Well, how many?
Oh my! Here he comes again. Rich has a question.
If you ask for a refrigerator and they go, it's 20 a night, you say, listen, I stay here all the time. I don't want to have to go across the street. They'll give you a free refrigerator. I do it all the time.
That's another way to avoid the costly minibar. You can get mini fridges sometimes in the room, and you can store your items that way. And usually there's no cost for that. And then again, if you've already created a relationship with the front desk agent or tipped or even the bellman, you can get a lot of things that would have a minimal charge. Just we'll take care of it, you know. Front desk is in charge of your bill. I can take all that stuff off.
Rich, what's that joke? I always love that you did with the coffee. What was it?
Oh, what
the coffee maker in the hotel or something?
One time I went to a place and I didn't have a coffee. I was staying at the Atlantis in the Bahamas and everything was like $1,000 and I didn't have coffee. So I went and bought instant coffee. There was no pot and I steamed water in my clothes steamer. And I made instant coffee.
Wow.
Prison coffee.
Because if you order it, it takes 45 minutes to an hour at the in the Bahamas, and it's $50.
I don't care what it is or how long it takes. I wouldn't use a fucking steam iron to make coffee. Yes. That's terrible.
Yes.
Rest, treat yourself.
You know, the
cup
water
of
scale in there built up, and
it's filthy.
It's like hard water.
Nasty. I was in a hotel one time, and there was the fire. I guess there was a fire in the hotel. Because the fire truck showed up, and I don't know if it was a drill or not, but this was like a terrace, so I was out there on the terrace smoking, which I know is probably illegal now, but it was like back then you could do it. And I was yelling down through the fire, and I was like, so should I get out? You know, because like no one would tell me, like they just had the bells going the whole time. So, but I could have jumped down. It was like one of those cheap, like, you know, like, you know, on the run hotels, you know, like just two levels.
Right.
Like, with a truck parked in front of your window.
On the
you remember
run,
one of those,
yeah,
like
yeah.
the serial killer truck?
Yeah.
I like the skankier hotels. I don't know.
Yeah, I like those too.
I tend to like less fancy places.
No, I like either, right? I like a fucking
gentleman's
hotel.
He's
like a diplomat, this guy.
I like, if it's not the fuck, I want a gentleman's accommodations,
yeah,
please.
Really nice.
I like 24-hour room service.
I want good bedding. Yeah. I want good soap.
Good conversation.
Anything good conversation.
Need, in the lobby.
Yeah.
Yes. I like to be welcomed.
I want a good workout
he likes to
room.
Be monocled. When he comes in,
I do.
They don't
know if it's me or Mr. Peanut.
I do enjoy a good hotel bar.
He does love a nice hotel.
Yeah. I like a good hotel bar, too, for some reason.
A lot of prostitutes in a hotel bar, actually.
Maybe that's it.
They love rolling around in there.
Yeah, you know? Huh?
Yeah. A lot of bed bugs in the hotel bar.
No, a lot of prostitutes.
Oh, yeah,
that's like their spot.
That's under the obvious chapter.
Right.
No!
The whores are where the booze is.
Too?
Wow.
In New York, or that's mainly Vegas, right?
No. Here, we've had to eliminate some from the bar that would come in all the time. You know, a couple guests got rolled and stuff. You know, they would put something in their drink, go up to their room, they wake
East
up.
East European.
Oh, man.
So you did mostly work in New York hotels, huh?
You take me to your room. We have a good time. Good time, very nice.
You put everything in the safe right the second you go in.
Yeah, what's with those little safes?
Yeah, what's up with the safes? You guys know how to get
into those
things?
Yeah, those are good. You should use those.
Oh, really?
Absolutely.
You can't get
your toothbrushes for your toothbrushes.
I'm definitely going to do that, man.
But what if you forgot your password? Then
security will come up and unlock it.
That means you guys.
I had that happen at the Borgata this past weekend.
Oh.
I was in there, and the fucking safe all of a sudden wouldn't work with my code, so they had to get the guy up there, punch it in.
Yeah.
I heard you did well. I saw some pictures.
Yeah.
Are you allowed to say?
I don't want to say.
Show me on your fingers. Get out of here.
That's nice. Yes.
Yep. Holy fuck. It's a nice hit.
It was huge.
You made $12?
$12.
Wow.
I couldn't fucking lose. I wanted to leave at noon on Sunday. I wound up staying until 11 p.m. on Sunday because at the same table. Didn't fucking get up. It just kept fucking stacking up. Stacking
Holy
up.
Fuck.
Kept doing. I was betting three spots, $6,000 a spot, and just couldn't
18,000?
Lose.
18,000? And wow. You won. That's an unlucky number, man. Oh, three sixes.
You know what?
It's not an unlucky number, you biblical idiot.
It's not, and it's not unlucky when you're doubling down on them and splitting and shit, too.
Don't make me beg you, Mark.
Here's a hotel.
Come with me.
I have one more question. Who are the worst travelers, like, of all the you know, countries and you
great
know?
Great question.
Like, who are the worst travelers? Yes. Is it Americans, or who is it? Asians,
as far as gratuities, or? Europeans are, you know, obviously shit. It's not their culture. You, like, you should see the look on a bellman's face when, like,
why
two
is it
of
not
us
their culture?
Of Italians pull up.
Oh,
like,
boy.
It's just like.
Really?
Yeah. So, and so then as rappers. Far as gratuities. actually, so, professional sports people, in my personal experience, yes. Professional athletes tend to be incredibly cheap and very rude.
Like, wow.
You know, they're
yes.
coming up and they're not even taking their headphones off. They're like, I need a new key. I'm like, you know.
They're jerk offs. They're absolutely jerk offs.
They're so the same jocks that they were in school. Mm. Yeah. Assholes.
I don't usually tip the bellman a lot of times, but I do my own luggage. Like when I'm in a hotel, sure. They don't do anything for me. I don't like my
shit. Let's go. Why don't you fucking grow? Go to the kitchen in a restaurant and bring out your own food and cut off the tip to the waitress.
Yeah.
I've done that.
Oh, sorry.
I've done that. I've walked right in and cooked. Didn't you see Top Chef, the herpes episode?
No, but there's got to be like one group where you're like, oh my God, I cannot believe, like, you know, these people are here.
Yes. Well, I mean, even groups. Business travelers, like when you just break it down to that, people who travel for business and they're in hotels all the time, those people, when they don't get what they want, or the, just the affluent black cards, oh my God,
yeah.
Those people scare me.
Is that what
you call
them?
What you want.
Yeah, that means that's wow. A funny black guy.
Wow. All right, let's get him out of here. Jacob, this
God.
Book looks excellent. Terrific.
We're all
book,
done. Okay. We're all done.
Yeah, look at that.
That was cool, dude.
Yeah, we're going to start our Thanksgiving, man.
Heads in yes. Beds, Jacob Tomsky. It really does. And are you doing any stuff? Plug his book signings, too. If you are, actually in New Orleans. We have people in New Orleans.
That's cool.
5:30 p.m. on the 28th, which is at the Garden District Bookshop.
Billy Bob Thornton.
And the 29th, only 7 to 7:45, Malaprops Bookstore in Asheville, North Carolina. So 20th, 29th, Jacob will be down south. Jacob Tomsky on Twitter, you can follow That's him cool. There. But this book looks really great, man. I wish I had it earlier.
I wish I read it. I wish I read it. I'd read it.
Yeah, there's no pictures either. You would have nothing to do with it. You'd wind up eating it like a fucking gerbil.
Rich, where are you going to be?
This weekend I'll be at Gotham. This week,
right?
And next weekend at JJ's Comedy in Jersey somewhere.
Right on,
that, where we did that pilot. Oh. You know what I'm talking about?
David, you got a lot going on.
Yeah, I got the DC Improv coming up on the 29th.
No tolerance today for him.
And,
for who, me?
Yeah. Well, I end up here?
I know, right?
It might not even be you. I'm ready for
sorry.
I'm ready for a few days. It might not even be
Dave's
you. I just
porn.
Have no tolerance for you today. Dave. Yes, Dave.
Davesoldporn.com, and you can follow it at oldporn. And this week, Amy Schumer and the guy who bangs Debbie and Debbie Does Dallas, holiday special. Man. Happy Thanksgiving.
That sounds great.
11 o'clock showtime.
Yes.
And I have...
Rich had a great appearance. It might be me. I'm
ready
for a few days. That's all.
All of us getting
That's
together
all.
Again.
Yeah. I have New Year's Eve. I will be in Buffalo. And Kenny, am I missing any gigs or is that it right now?
That's it.
New Year's Eve week, Buffalo.
Yeah.
And I have a new CD coming out called No Baby For You. And it comes out on the 11th of December. It's an old set. I taped it in 2007. Some of the material's from Monster Rain, but it's a great set, so I'm releasing it. I just don't want anybody complaining.
Very nice. I want to bring up Sunday, December 23rd. I know it's a while away, but you just keep your plans there. 89 North Music Venue. It's called 89 North Music Venue. 89 North Ocean Avenue. Mm. It's me, Joe, Rotgut, fucking Almost a Journey, and you two going to be playing there. All night that night. It's going to be
That sounds like a cool show. It's a
great show. This weekend I'm at Gotham, and we have a podcast, My Wife Hates Me, this week was a very good one.
They're all good.
This week was good.
Why were you away?
I like the podcast.
Huh? And next week, J&J Comedy.
All right. Thank you very much, Jacob. And, of course,
Dave Attell and Rich Voss. My God, what a show.
Thanks for having us, guys.
Yes. Thank you for having us.
Thank you so much.
All right.
First time, long time.
Enjoy your Thanksgiving. And, we'll see
you
Monday.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Next
live show Monday. But we got a big, Best of special?
Yeah.
What Chip is hosting it.
Chip's hosting it.
All right.
For two days.
Nice.
Oh, boy.
Chip is hosting.
What kind of bits? The best of the comics, right?
Comics, yeah.
So all the funny people we've had on in the last year or so.
Good.
Very good.
Their best bits. Oh, or some of their best bits. Dave Attell might have made it. You think he made it, Dave?
I don't know, man. I don't know. I feel like I dropped the ball this whole time here.
Oh, my God. You had very poignant questions.
No, but
I had some very funny slams on that cover.
And when you talked about smoking on the balcony, it was riveting.
It was good, right? I thought it was excellent.
What an asshole.
But how could, I couldn't hit a home run off of that setup of this Arab-Israeli thing. you gave me slow balls.
That set the table for the rest of the appearance, huh?
But I think that's going to be a great way to celebrate the holidays, listen to some of the best jams or, I'm sure there's going to be some rank outs and a couple of,
Well, there's going to be, it's segments...
Oh, my God, no.
All
right.
Are you shitting?
You play with him.
No.
Tape.
Was there a shitting noise? Dave. We know this guy.
No, I won't be.
During the year.
Sorry.
All right. See you guys Monday. Happy Thanksgiving.